The message, What is the Attraction on the Mountain, was delivered on Sunday evening, July 25, 1965, at the Branham Tabernacle, Jeffersonville, Indiana, USA. Die boodskap, Wat is die aantrekkingskrag op die berg, was gelever op zondagavond, 25 juli 1965, by die Branham Tabernacle, Jeffersonville, Indiana, VSA.
Let's bow our heads now.
Glo net, alles is moontlik, glo net. Laat ons nou ons hoofde buig.
Father God, that's our sincere prayer tonight.
Vader God, dis ons opregte gebed vanaand.
Seeing all that you are doing for the people in this day.
Ten aanskoue van alles wat u doen vir die mense in hierdie dag.
And we ask you, Lord, may we only believe.
En ons vra u Here, mag ons net glo.
Just believe it's the truth, the written word being made manifest to us.
Net glo, dis die waarheid, die geskrewe woord gemanifesteer aan ons.
Grant these things, Father.
Skenk hierdie dinge, Vader.
Now tonight, we want to thank you for the light that you throw on the scriptures for us this morning.
Nou vanaand wil ons u dank vir die lig wat u op die skrifte gewerp het vir ons vanmôre.
And we pray tonight, Lord, in the prayer line, that you will vindicate your word to be the truth.
En ons bid vanaand, Here, in daardie gebedslyn, dat u woord as die waarheid sal bevestig.
We pray for all the churches and the congregations that's gathered around the little microphones out across from the nation.
Ons bid vir al die kerke en die gemeentes wat vergader is rondom die klein mikrofoontjies buite oor van die nasie.
All the way to the west coast, up into the mountains of Arizona.
Die heel pad na die weskus, op na die berge van Arizona.
Down into the plains of Texas, way into the east coast.
Af in die vlaktes van Texas, ver in die ooskus.
All across the country, Lord, where they have gathered.
Hoor al oor die land, Here, waar hulle bymekaar gekom het.
Many hours apart we are in time, but Lord, we're together tonight as one unit, believers waiting for the coming of the Messiah.
Baie ure uitmekaar is ons in tyd, maar Here, ons is vanaand bymekaar as een, eenheid. Gelowiges in afwagting vir die koms van die Messias.
We pray, Heavenly Father, that you'll send him soon for your church.
Ons bid, Hemelse Vader, dat u hom spoedig sal stuur vir u kerk.
For we ask it in his name, amen. You may be seated.
Want ons vra dit in sy naam, amen. Julle mag maar sit.
Christian greetings to all that's here tonight.
Christen groete aan almal wat hier is vanaand.
I'm sorry that we're still jammed and packed till we can hardly breathe.
Ek is jammer, ons is steeds so ingedruk en vol tot ons skaars kan asemhaal.
Even the air conditioners, as well as this air conditioning, doesn't have much effect. So many people.
Selfs die ligversorgers, so goed soos dit lig versorgd is, het nie veel effect nie, soveel mense.
If it was hardly just a normal church full of people, those air conditioners would freeze you.
As daar kwalik net 'n normale kerk vol mense was, so daar die ligversorgers julle laat vries.
But now, everyone's got a fan fanning, and the air conditioner is blowing as hard as they can.
Maar nou het almal 'n waaier aan die waai, en die ligversorger blaas so hard as wat dit kan.
We send greetings from the east coast to the west. To all our friends in Christ who's listening in.
Ons stuur groete vanaf die ooskus na die weste, na al ons vriende in Christus wat inluister.
We send greetings over in San Jose, Brother Borders, the group up there.
Ons stuur groete oorkant na San Jose, Broer Boris, die groep daarbo.
We send greetings up in the mountains, Prescott, Arizona, to Brother Leo Mercer and his group that's up there waiting for the coming of the Lord.
Ons stuur groete op na die berge, Prescott, Arizona, na Broer Leo Mercer en sy groep wat daarbo is, in afwagting vir die koms van die Here.
We send greetings to those in Tucson that's gathered tonight waiting for the coming of the Lord.
Ons stuur groete na hulle in Tucson, wat vanaand by mekaar gekom het, in afwagting vir die koms van die Here.
Down in Houston, Texas, to those who are waiting for the coming of the Lord.
Onder in Houston, Texas, aan hulle wat wag vir die koms van die Here.
Up in Chicago, to those who are waiting for the coming of the Lord.
Bo in Chicago, aan hulle wat wag vir die koms van die Here.
Up on the East Coast, New York, and Connecticut, and the great groups up there that's waiting for the coming of the Lord.
Bo op die Ooskus, New York en Connecticut en die groot groepe daarbo wat wag vir die koms van die Here.
We don't have room here to seat them, so we just have to send them the word through the medium of the telephone.
Ons het nie plek om hulle te laat sit nie, so ons moet net vir hulle die woord stuur deur die medium van die telefoon.
We send greetings to Brother Junior Jackson tonight and his group down in Clarksville.
Ons stuur groete aan broer Junior Jackson vanaand en sy groep onder in Clarksville.
Brother Ruddle up on 62 and his group waiting for the coming of the Lord.
Broer Ruddle bo op 62 en sy groep in afwagting vir die koms van die Here.
And we're gathered here tonight at the home church, the tabernacle, waiting for the coming of the Lord.
En ons is vanaand hier vergader by die tuiskerk, die tabernakel, in afwagting vir die koms van die Here.
And now, many of you maybe wasn't at the services this morning.
En nou, baie van julle was miskien nie by die dienste van môre nie.
But I trust that everyone that wasn't will get that tape.
Maar ek vertrou dat elkeen wat nie was nie, daar die band sal kry.
Or I believe that it was the most straightest message to the church since the message of sirs, what time is it?
Want ek glo dat het die reguitste boodskap aan die kerk was, sedert die boodskap van meneer, wat tyd is dit?
I felt the anointing of the Spirit, felt led to say what I did.
Ek het die salwing van die Gees gevoel, gelei gevoel om te sê wat ek het.
It was long, but yet I felt led to do it.
Dit was lank, maar toch het ek gelei gevoel om dit te doen.
And I think the Lord by His Word showed that what hour we're living.
En ek dink die Here het deur sy woord gewys wat hier ons in lewe.
And it makes sure that we understand these mysterious things that's happening.
En maak seker dat julle hier die geheimsinnige dinge verstaan wat gebeur.
You know, the Bible said, the wise shall understand.
Julle weet, die Bybel het gesê, die wyse sal verstaan.
But the nations and the people will grow weaker and wiser.
Maar die volke en die mense sal swakker en wyser word.
Just think, the average American now is in middle age about 20 years old. Weaker, but wiser.
Dink net, die gemiddelde Amerikaner is nou in die middeljare omtrent 20 jaar oud. Swakker, maar wyser.
They didn't have jet planes in them days and atomic warheads, but they lived a lot longer.
Hulle het nie in daardie dae straalvliegtuie en atoomplofkoppe gehad nie, maar hulle het baie langer gelewe.
We're getting weaker and wiser, and our own wisdom is what's going to destroy us.
Ons word swakker en wyser, en ons eie wysheid is wat ons gaan vernietig.
We will destroy ourselves. God will not destroy us. Our wisdom will destroy us.
Ons sal onsself vernietig. God sal ons nie vernietig nie. Ons wysheid sal ons vernietig.
It's always been that way, and so will it be again.
Dit was altyd so, en dit sal weer so wees.
Now, the Lord willing, next Sunday morning, not knowing now what I will speak on.
Nou, die Here wil, volgende Sondagoggend, onbekend nou waaroor ek gaan praat.
But I trust that the Lord, if He lets us live and nothing happens, and it be His will.
Maar ek vertrou dat die Here, as Hy ons laat lewe en niks gebeur nie, en dit sal sy wil wees.
We aim to speak another message next Sunday morning. Have prayer for the sick next Sunday night.
Beoog ons om nog 'n boodskap te preek volgende Sondagoggend. Gebed te hê vir die siekes volgende Sondagaand.
Then it falls my lot to return back home to Arizona to take the family back so that the children can register in school.
Dan is dit my lot om terug te keer huis toe na Arizona om die familie terug te neem sodat die kinders kan registreer in die skool.
Then we'll notify you just as we can of the meetings as they mature or the times that we places that we aim to be.
Dan sal ons sal julle laat weet net soos ons kan van die dienste soos hulle vorder of die tye wat ons plekke waar ons beoog om te wees.
So God bless you all.
So God seën julle almal.
Now tonight, knowing that I'm 15 minutes late to begin with.
Nou vanaand, in die wete dat dit is, ek's 15 minute laat om mee te begin.
Quarter till 8 here in Jeffersonville. And that's about a quarter to 9 at the East Coast.
Kwart voor 8 hier in Jeffersonville. En dis omtrent 'n kwart voor 9 aan die Ooskus.
And then it's about 5 o'clock on the West Coast.
En dan is dit omtrent 5 uur aan die Weskus.
So now we are just about sundown here.
So nou is ons net omtrent son onder hier.
And I want to speak to you for just a short service to try to find the anointing of the Spirit and then call the prayer line.
En ek wil met julle praat vir net 'n kort diens om die salwing van die Gees te probeer vind en dan die gebedslyn roep.
Now I want the congregation here as well as the congregation assembled at other places.
En ek wil hê die gemeente hier, sowel as die gemeente vergader by ander plekke.
Find some man, some brother, that's anointed by the Spirit.
Moet 'n man vind, 'n broer wat gesalf is deur die Gees.
And when we start praying for the sick, go lay hands upon those that's in your congregation.
En wanneer ons begin bid vir die siekes, gaan lê hande op hulle wat in julle gemeente is.
Remember, God is omnipresent. He is everywhere.
Onthou, God is alomteenwoordig. Hy is oral.
So, down in Texas, over in California, up in Arizona, wherever you are.
So, onder in Texas, oorkant in California, bo in Arizona, waar jy ook al is.
Lay hands on those that are sick when we start praying for the sick.
Lay hand op hulle wat siek is, wanneer ons begin bid vir die siek is.
And I'm sure God will hear and answer prayer.
En ek is seker God sal hoor en gebed se beantwoord.
Strange thing last Sunday night, and the anointing was going on in the Holy Spirit.
Vreemde ding verlede Sondag aand, en die salwing het voortgegaan en die Heilige Gees.
It's quite a thing. I hadn't had a line of discernment for months and months since I was here the other time.
Dit was nogal 'n ding. Ek het nie 'n onderskeidingslyn gehad vir maande en maande vandat ek nou die keer hier was nie.
Then to walk up there under a promise, you don't know that he'll do it.
En dan om daar op te loop onder 'n belofte, jy weet nie dat hy dit sal doen nie.
You can't say he'll do it.
Jy kan nie sê hy sal dit doen nie.
You just got to walk up there and wait.
Jy moet net daar op loop en wag.
He's sovereign. He does what he wants to.
Hy is soewerein. Hy maak wat hy wil.
But stand there and wait to see what he will do.
Maar daar staan en wag wat hy sal doen.
Then feel it break through on you like that.
En dan deur jou voel breek soos daardie.
And at the end of the meeting, not knowing who it was.
En aan die einde van die diens, onbekend wie dit was.
But there'd been a man somewhere along the line that was tall, bald on top. And he was a very sick person.
Maar daar was 'n man iewers in die lyn was lank en bleeskop en hy was 'n baie siek persoon.
Then right at last there was a man appeared here on the platform.
En toe reg aan die einde het daar 'n man verskyn hier op die platform.
And had his head down and looked like he was suffering, holding himself around the stomach.
En sy hoof was gebuig en gelyk asof hy ly. Homself vasgehou om die maag.
And I thought that must be that first man or second man or whatever it was that I prayed for.
En ek het gedink dit moet daar die eerste man of tweede man wees of wanneer ook al dit was dat ek vir hom gebid het.
Because He was bald and was holding his head down, a large man, stooped over.
Want hy was bles en sy hoof was gebuig, 'n groot man, oorgebuig.
But I looked around and I found the gentleman sitting out there, but he was rejoicing.
Maar ek het rond gekyk en ek het die man gevind wat daar buite sit, maar hy was aan die juig.
I thought, where is it?
Ek het gedink, waar is dit?
I couldn't decide where it was at.
Ek kon nie besluit waar dit was nie.
I could feel it and see the man before me.
Ek kon dit voel en die man voor my sien.
I felt it pull around this way and it was coming from back.
Ek het dit na hierdie kant toe voel trek en dit het van agteraf gekom.
I looked at Brother Neville and these two sitting here, it wasn't them.
Ek het na Brother Neville gekyk en hierdie twee wat hier sit, dit was nie hulle nie.
I said, the man is on the inside of that baptistry back there.
Ek het gesê, die man is aan die binnenkant van daardie doopbad daarachter.
And you know who it was? Brother Shepherd.
En weet julle wie dit was? Broer Shepherd.
Reason I couldn't recognize him, he's sitting back there with his head bowed, praying.
Die rede waarom ek hom nie kon herken nie, hy het daarachter gesit met sy hoof gebuig, aan die bid.
He thought he was going to die, has thought that for the last few weeks.
Hy het gedink hy sou sterf, het het gedink vir die laaste paar weke.
His wife told him, go get a new pair of shoes, and he said, I won't need them. I won't be here that long.
Sy vrou het vir hom gesê om 'n nuwe paar skoene te gaan kry, en hy het gesê, ek sal hulle nie nodig hê nie, ek sal nie so lank hier wees nie.
And he met me the other day, up there in the yard, Brother Woods is shouting and praising God.
En hy het my nou die dag ontmoet in die, daarbo op die werf, Broer Hoedsen, aan die skree en God prijs.
Said, I'm eating bacon, eggs, tomatoes, anything I want.
Gesê, ek eet spek, eiers, tomaties, enig iets wat ek wil.
And humbly, giving up his seat, getting back in there, out of the way, and praying.
En nederig, sy sitplek opgegee, daarachter ingegaan, oor die pad uit, en gebid.
You see, you don't need a prayer card, you only need faith, see.
Sien, jy het nie 'n gebedskaart nodig nie, jy het net geloof nodig, sien.
I didn't know whether he was healed or not, I just said, a man praying has got something wrong.
Nou, ek het nie geweet of hy genees is of nie. Ek het net gesê, 'n man aan die bid, hy het iets verkeerd.
I think you call what it was, stomach trouble, and praying back behind here.
Ek dink dit het genoem wat het was, maagprobleem, en bid hierachter.
The Lord Jesus make you well. Now that's all I could tell.
Die Here Jesus maak jou gesond. Nou dis al wat ek kon sê.
The pull was that he was praying.
Die trek was dat hy gebid het.
I could see it, but what happens, I don't know. See?
Ek kon dit sien, maar wat gebeur het, weet ek nie. Sien?
But when you see it come back, everybody's aware. When it says, thus saith the Lord. See, that's not me speaking no more then. That's him.
Maar wanneer jy dit woord terugkom, is almal bewus, wanneer dit sê, so spreek die Here, sien, dis dan nie meer ek wat praat nie, dis hy.
But I always say, Jesus Christ has made you whole. That's exactly the truth.
Maar ek sê altyd, Jesus Christus het jou gesond gemaak, dis precies die waarheid.
He was wounded for our transgressions. With his stripes, we were healed, see?
Hy is deurboor vir ons oortredinge. Deur sy wonde is ons genees. Sien? Sien?
But when it comes thus saith the Lord and tells you what to do and what's going to happen, watch that. It'll be that way.
Maar wanneer dit kom, so spreek die Here en jou sê wat om te doen en wat gaan gebeur, hou dit dop. Dit sal so wees.
But when I say Jesus Christ heals you and makes you whole, you believe it. Because he's already said it. I'm just repeating what he said.
Maar wanneer ek sê, Jesus Christus genees jou en maak jou gesond, glo jy dit? Want hy het dit al reeds gesê, ek herhaal net wat hy gesê het.
And a vision is just repeating what he showed. You understand?
En a visioen is net die herhaling van wat hy gewys het. Verstaan julle?
Now, may we hurry up and get right into the word. Because I know that many of you are here, got long miles to travel tonight.
Nou, mag ons opskit en reg in die woord ingaan, want ek weet baie van julle is hier, het lang myle om vanaand te reis.
I pray that God will bless you, help you and protect you along the roads.
Ek bid dat God julle sal seën, julle sal help en julle sal beskerm langs die paaie.
And now, I wish to turn tonight to St. Matthew, the 21st chapter, and verses 1 to 11 in St. Matthew.
En nou wil ek vanaand blaai na Matteus, die 21ste hoofstuk en verse 1 tot 11 in Matteus.
And now, if you don't have your Bible, or if you want to jot down these scriptures, all right.
En nou, as jylle nie jylle Bijbel het nie, of as jylle hier die skrifte wil neerskryf, goed.
Now to you who never heard the message this morning, and you have a tape recorder.
En nou, aan jylle wat nooit die boodskap vanmorgen gehoor het nie, en jylle het een bandopnemer.
We never solicit selling tapes. We never solicit selling anything.
Ons werf nooit band verkoop nie. Ons werf nooit om enigiets te verkoop nie.
Sometimes in a big meeting they'll announce they got some books back there.
Partymaal in 'n groot diens sal hulle aankondig hulle het 'n paar boeke daar agter.
We don't make anything out of them. Brother Dale's a writer.
Ons maak niks uit hulle nie. Broer Weil is die skrywer.
The tapes. The man operates the tape business there will tell you. We don't make no tape money.
Die bande, die man wat die band besigheid bedryf, daar sal julle sê, ons maak geen band geld nie.
We don't think the tapes, it's the message.
Ons maak nie, dit is nie die bande nie, dis die boodskap.
And when a man gets on his mind that it's money, he ain't gonna make tapes no more. That's right.
En wanneer 'n man het in sy gedagte kry dat het geld is, gaan hy nie meer bande maak nie. Dis reg.
As asked about it, I think our tapes sell about under $5 or something, 3 to 5 or something like that.
Ek het daaroor gevra, ek dink ons bande verkoop omtrent onder $5 of iets, 3 tot 5 of iets soos dit.
What I say? 3 and 4 for them big long tapes.
Hoe sê? 3 en 4 vir daardie groot lang bande.
And a certain minister, I asked about one of his tapes and it was $9.
En 'n sekere prediker, ek het gevra oor een van sy bande en het was $9.
About 20 minutes or 30 of a message.
Omtrent 20 of 30 minute van 'n boodskap.
So I see that our brother Softman back there is not getting rich any of them on these tapes that they're putting out.
So ek sien dat ons broer Softman daar agter nie ryk word enige van hulle op hierdie bande wat hulle uitsit nie.
See, they make just enough to get by.
Sien, hulle maak net genoeg om oor die weg te kom mee.
Can't ask them to make them for nothing because they have to buy the tapes and everything else.
Kan hulle nie vra om hulle vir niks te maak nie, want hulle moet die bande en alles koop.
Machinery is very expensive. Cost about $10,000 to get set up to make those tapes to begin with.
En die machinery is baie duur. Kost omtrent $10,000 om opgesteld te word, om daar die bande te maak, om mee te begin.
Now I understand soon, I haven't announced it yet, but there's a tape hearing again.
Nou, ek verstaan dat ek gou, het het al aangekondig, maar daar's weer 'n band sitting.
Ever so often, the trustees, I have nothing to do with it at all.
Elke dan en van die trustees, ek het hoegenaamd niks daarmee te doen nie.
I don't even number none of the meetings, it's neither mere pro nor con.
Ek is nie eens nooit by enige van die vergaderings nie, dis nie vir of teen nie.
They turn in their bids, the trustees decide who is the next man to make tapes and they send him a letter. That's all I know about it.
Hulle gee hulle bod in, die trustees besluit wie is die volgende man om die bande te maak. En hulle stuur vir hom 'n brief. Dis al wat ek daarvan weet.
They take care of that because I can't even dedicate babies, let alone take care of tapes. So, or baptize.
Hulle sorg daarvoor, want ek kan nie eens babes toewy nie. Wat nog van sorg van bande, so, of doop?
So I've got my mind set on this message. That's that third pull, and it's the one I must be loyal and reverent to.
So, ek het my gedagtes gerig op hierdie boodskap. Dis daar die derde trek, en dis die een waarin ek getrou en eerbiedig moet wees.
Matthew 21, 1 to 11, I said that so you could be watching for the, or turning to the scriptures.
Matthew 21, 1 tot 11, ek het daar die gesê, so dat julle kan uitkyk vir die, of blaai na die skrifte.
And when they drew nigh unto Jerusalem, and were come to Bethphage, unto the mount, of Olives.
En toe die en toe hulle naby Jerusalem gekom en Betfage aan die Olyfberg bereik het.
Jesus sent two of his disciples and saying unto them,
stuur Jesus twee van sy disippels uit en sê vir hulle,
go into the village over against you and straightway you shall find an ass tied and a colt with her.
Ga na daardie dorp reg voor julle en dadelik sal julle 'n eseling vind wat vasgemaak is en 'n vul by haar.
Loose them and bring them to me.
Maak haar los en bring hulle vir my.
And if any man say aught unto you, you shall say the Lord has need of them, and straightway he will send them.
En as iemand vir julle iets sê, moet julle antwoord. Die Here het hulle nodig en dadelik sal hy hulle stuur.
This was all done that it might be fulfilled which is spoken by the prophet, saying.
En dit het alles gebeur sodat vervul sou word die woord wat deur die profeet gespreek is.
Tell ye the daughters of Zion, behold, thy king cometh unto thee meek, sitting upon an ass, and a colt, the foal of an ass.
Sê vir die dogters van Sion, kyk, jou koning kom na jou toe sagmoedig. Hy sit op 'n esel, ja, 'n jong esel, die foal van 'n pakdier.
And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them.
En die disippels het gegaan en gedoen soos Jesus hulle beveel het.
And they brought the ass and the colt and put on them their clothes and they set him thereon.
Hulle het die esel en die vol gebring en hulle klere daarop gelê en hy het daarop gaan sit.
And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way.
En die grootste deel van die skare het hulle klere op die pad oorgegooi.
And others cut out branches from the trees and strew them in the way.
En ander hul takke van die bome afgekap en op die pad gestrooi.
And the multitude that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David.
En die skare wat voorgeloop en die wat gevolg het, het uitgeroep en gesê, Hosanna vir die Seun van David.
Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Geseend is hy wat kom in die naam van die Here. Hosanna in die hoogste hemele.
And when he was come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, Who is this?
En toe hy in Jerusalem inkom, het die hele stad in opskudding geraak en gesê, Wie is hier die man?
And the multitude said, This is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee.
En die skare sê, Dit is Jesus, die profeet van Nazareth in Galilea.
Now if I would take a text from that for about 30 minutes before the prayer line begins.
Nou, as ek 'n teks daaruit sou neem vir omtrent 30 minute voor die gebedslyn begin.
I would like to take this for a text. What is the attraction on the mountain?
Wil ek graag hierdie neem vir 'n teks. Wat is die aantrekkingskrag op die berg?
Now, it had been a very weary, nervous day. And it's an unusual day.
Nou, dit was 'n baie vermoeiende, senuweeagtige dag. En dit was 'n ongewone dag.
We find Jesus here coming up to Jerusalem, ready to attend the Passover.
Ons vind Jesus hier opkom na Jerusalem, gereed om die Pasga by te woon.
And the Passover is where the Paschal lamb was killed and the blood was spread upon the mercy seat for the atonement for the people.
En die Pascha is waar die Paschalam doodgemaak is en die bloed was gesmeer op die genade troon vir die verzoening vir die volk.
And he had come up from Bethphage and had come to the top of the Mount of Olives.
En het opgekom van Beit Wagge en het bo op die Olijfberg gekom.
Which looks down upon another little hill where Jerusalem was built.
Wat afkyk op nog 'n heuweltjie waar Jerusalem gebou was.
As he looked to know that this was his final visit.
En soos hy gekyk het en geweet het dat dit was sy finale besoek.
This was the time that when he would be delivered into the hands of sinful man and they would kill him.
Dit was die tyd dat toe hy oorgelewer sou word in die hande van sondige manne en hulle hom sou doodmaak.
He died the horriblest death that was ever died by a mortal and be buried.
Hy sou die verskriklikste dood sterf wat ooit gesterf is deur 'n sterveling en begrawe word.
He'd be betrayed by his own, some of them standing right with him.
Hy sou verraai word deur sy eie, party van hulle wat reg langs hom gestaan het.
And him being God knew what was in their hearts and knew from the beginning who would betray him.
En hy as God het geweet wat in hulle harte was en het van die begin af geweet wie hom sou verraai.
And know that man was with him who sat by his side, counted his money to him and so forth.
En het geweet daardie man was by hom wat aan sy sy gesit het en sy geld vir hom getel het en so voort.
Know that man would betray him.
Het geweet daardie man sou hom verraai.
And knew that a cruel Roman cross waited for him out there.
En het geweet dat 'n wrede Romeinse kruis daar buite vir hom gewag het.
He knew that his water and his body and the blood of his body would separate.
Hy het geweet dat sy water in sy liggaam en die bloed van sy liggaam sou skei.
And the blood would drop off of his forehead, great big drops like perspiration.
En dat die bloed van sy voorkop sou drup, ijslike groot druppels soos sweet.
He knew all that was before him.
Hy het geweet dat dit alles vir hom voorgelê.
And he stands upon the mountain looking over to Jerusalem.
En hy staan op die berg en kyk oor na Jerusalem.
The people of that day, what they call that day a better religious class of people, hated him.
Die mense van daardie dag, die wat hulle daardie dag genoem het, 'n beter klas godsdienstige mense, het hom gehaat.
The churches of that day hated him and denounced him and denounced all that listened to him.
Die kerke van daardie dag het hom gehaat en hom veroordeel. En almal wat na hom geluister het, veroordeel.
If they went and attended his campaigns, they were immediately excommunicated from the fellowship of the church.
En as hulle gegaan en sy veldtogte bygewoon het, was hulle dadelik geëkskommuniseer uit die gemeenskap van die kerk.
No wonder the scripture said he came unto his own. And his own received him not.
Geen wonder die skrif het gesê nie. Hy het na sy eie gekom en sy eie het hom nie ontvang nie.
The ones who ought to have loved him, the ones who ought to have been for him, was his bitterest enemies.
Diegene wat hom lief behoort te gehad het, diegene wat vir hom behoort te gewees het, was sy bitterste vyande.
And he had made up his little group out of a bunch of poor people, fishermen, tax gatherers, uneducated.
En het sy 'n klein groepie saamgestel uit 'n klomp arme mense, vissermanne, belastinggaders, onopgevoed.
The Bible said some of them was even ignorant, unlearned.
Die Bybel het gesê sommige van hulle was selfs onkundig, ongeletterd.
Some could not even sign their name.
Party kon nie eens hulle naam teken nie.
He never went to the churches to get his people.
Hy het nooit na die kerke gegaan om sy mense te kry nie.
And he never agreed with any of the church leaders.
En het nooit saamgestem met enige van die kerkleiers nie.
And besides that, he followed the very trend of a prophet.
En behalwe dit, het hy die eenste gang van 'n profeet gevolg.
He condemned everything that they done.
Hy het alles veroordeel wat hulle gedoen het.
As the ones before him had.
Soos diegene voor hom gemaak het.
Because they were a portion of the word and he was the word in its fullness.
Want hulle was 'n deel van die woord en hy was die woord in sy volheid.
But in the midst of all of it, through every age and every prophet that had been or would be.
Maar te midde van dit alles, deur elke eeu en elke profeet wat was of sal wees.
There's going to be a certain amount of people that's predestinated to hear that message and they'll follow it.
Gaan daar 'n sekere getal mense wees wat voorbestem is om daardie boodskap te hoor en hulle sal dit volg.
Those ignore the crowds. They ignore the criticism of the unbeliever.
Hulle ignoreer die skares. Hulle ignoreer die kritiek van die ongelowige.
They have no argument with them.
Hulle het geen argument met hulle nie.
They've got one thing to do, that's believe. And to get every bit of it they can.
Hulle het een ding om te doen, dis glo. En elke deeltjie daarvan kry wat hulle kan.
Soak it in. Like Mary who sat at the feet of Jesus.
Dit in te neem,
soos Maria wat aan die voete van Jesus gesit het.
And Martha was fixing his dinner. And Jesus said to her,
en Martha het sy middagete gereed gemaak en Jesus het vir haar gesê,
but Martha, you are so concerned about the things of life.
Maar Martha, jy is so besorg oor die dinge van die lewe.
But Mary has sought the better things. See? The things of eternal life.
Maar Maria het die beter dinge gesoek. Sien? Die dinge van ewige lewe.
Now we find that many of the people that had understood.
Nou ons vind dat baie van die mense wat verstaan het,
they didn't have literature as we have today. They didn't have television or telephones or anything of that day.
Hulle het nie literatuur gehad soos ons vandag het nie. Hulle het nie televisie of telefoon of enigiets gehad van daardie dag nie.
But it been kindly breezed around that he was going to be at the Passover.
Maar dit was soort van rond vertel dat hy by die Pascha sou wees.
For many of the people being spiritual minded knew that he was that Passover lamb.
Want baie van die mense wat geestelik ingestel was, het geweet dat hy die Pascha lam was.
Because he'd already told them the things that was going to happen.
Want hy het hulle alreeds die dinge vertel wat sou gebeur.
And then of course knowing that he was to be there and loved him the way they did, they was waiting for him.
En toe natuurlik in die wete dat hy daar sou wees en hom lief gehad het soos hulle het, het hulle vir hom gewag.
There was a crowd that was probably pushing, shoving from one gate to the other.
Daar was 'n skare wat waarskynlik gedruk het van die een hek na die ander gedruk het.
Watching out in every way, for they knew that one of the hours he would appear. They were watching.
Hy het gekyk het op enige manier, want hy het geweet dat een van die ure hy sou verskyn. Hy het uitgekyk.
Others were wondering what was the matter with these people, running from gate to gate. What's the attraction?
Andere het gewonder wat fout was met hierdie mense, wat van hek tot hek gehardloop het. Wat is die aantrekkingskrag?
And they would look this way and look that way to find out.
En hulle sou na hierdie kant kyk en na daardie kant kyk om uit te vind.
Looked like they were looking for something. Under expectation of something going to happen.
Gelyk asof hulle soek na iets. Onder verwagting van iets wat gaan gebeur.
Oh, how I would like to change my text for a few minutes. And say this. That's what's the matter today.
Wou graag ek my teks wil verander vir 'n paar minute. En dit sê. Dat dit die probleem vandag is.
The people who are looking for him coming is under great anticipation and expectation.
Die mense wat vandag uitkyk vir hom om te kom, is onder groot verwagting en afwagting.
We can feel it. The pressure.
Ons kan dit voel. Die druk.
And they're seeking, watching every move and every sign, comparing it with the scriptures.
En hulle soek. Hou elke beweging en elke teken dop. Vergelyk dit met die skrifte.
And when they seen all those things that was predicted of him, right up to the end, they know the end was nigh.
En toe hulle al daardie dinge gesien het wat voorspel was van hom, reg tot by die einde, het hulle geweet die einde was naby.
They wanted to be there. So they watched.
Hulle wou daar wees. So hulle dopgehou.
Part of the crowds was for him, in the minority.
Deel van die skares was vir hom. In die minderheid.
Some was against him, most of them. 90% was against him.
Party was teen hom. Meeste van hulle. 90% was teen hom.
And that's about the way it is today.
En dis omtrent hoe dit vandag is.
In the religious crowds, when it really come down to the word and Christ, there's about 1% that would believe it.
In die godsdienstige skares, wanneer dit regtig neerkom op die woord en Christus, is daar omtrent 1% wat dit sou glo.
The other part wouldn't pay attention to it, no matter what was done.
Die ander deel sal geen aandag daarin skenk nie. Maak nie saak wat gedoen was nie.
They'd pass off some kind of a joke or throw a slam about it.
Hulle sal een of ander soort grap maak of spot daarmee drijf.
Just about the same.
Net omtrent dieselfde.
Things don't change very much. History just repeats itself. around.
Tyd, dinge verander nie veel nie. Geskiedenis herhaal homself net weer.
Well, we find that drawed a nervous tension. It had to. It must do it.
Wel, ons vind, dit het 'n senuweespanning veroorsaak. Dit moes, dit moet dit doen.
They were waiting, they were wondering what he would do when he got there.
Hulle het gewag, hulle het gewonder wat hy sou doen as hy daar kom.
They wanted to be there to get anything that he'd done, they wanted it.
Hulle wou daar wees om alles te kry wat hy gedoen het. Hulle wou dit hê.
They wanted to see it, they believed him.
Hulle wou dit sien, hulle het hom geglo.
Others had heard he was coming, and they went up there to make fun of him.
Ander het gehoor hy was aan die kom, en hulle het soontoe gegaan om die spot te dryf met hom.
So after all the nervous anticipation, very unusual day, very unusual time.
So, na al die senuweeagtige afwagting, 'n baie ongewone dag, baie ongewone tyd.
Church is asleep. The people's nerve was on edge. There were so many people there. Then it happened.
Kerke aan die slaap. Was die mense se senuwees op breekpunt? Daar was so baie mense daar. En toe het dit gebeur.
On top of Mount Olive come a little white donkey. Coming walking down the hill.
Bo op die Olyfberg kom 'n klein wit donkie aan die kom. Wat teen die heuwel afloop.
With a group of people fanatically screaming, pulling off palms, leaves off the trees.
Met 'n groep mense wat fanaties skree, palmblare van die bome aftrek.
Throwing their clothes in the road, screaming, Hosanna to the Son of David that comes in the name of the Lord.
Hulle klere in die pad gooi, skree, Hosanna aan die Seun van Dawid, wat kom in die naam van die Here.
This little mule, his rider was none other than God's anointed Messiah of the hour.
Die hierdie klein muil, sy ruiter was niemand anders as God se gesalde Messias van die uur nie.
God then, what was he doing?
God te, wat was hy aan die doen?
What is that attraction up there on the hill?
Wat is die aantrekkingskrag daarbo op die heuwel?
It's God making history and God fulfilling prophecy.
Dis God wat geskiedenis maak en God wat profesie vervul.
And that always causes an attraction.
En dit veroorsaak altyd 'n aantrekkingskrag.
It brings all the critics up, the vultures of this morning's message, and the eagles also. See?
Dit bring al die kritici na vore, die aasvoels van vanmôre se boodskap, en die arende ook, sien?
They come together to find out what's going on.
Hulle het bymekaar gekom om uit te vind wat gaan aan.
Some coming for curiosity, some coming to find fault. Others coming to criticize.
Party het gekom uit nieuwsgierigheid. Party het gekom om fout te vind. Ander het gekom om te kritiseer.
There's all kinds gathered, as we said this morning, believers, make-believers, and unbelievers.
Daar's alle soorte bymekaar, soos ons vanmôre gesê het, gelowiges, skyngelowiges, en ongelowiges.
What's on the mountain? Prophecy is being fulfilled.
Wat's op die berg? Profesie word vervul.
Now, we'll see what takes place.
Nou, ons sal sien wat plaasvind.
Now, in the book of Zechariah, in the 9th chapter and the 9th verse.
Nou, in die boek van Zechariah, in die 9de hoofstuk en die 9de vers.
Zechariah, one of the prophets, spoke in the spirit saying this.
Zechariah, een van die profete, het gespreek in die gees. En dit gesê,
Rejoice greatly, O daughters of Zion.
Verheug jou grootliks, O dogters van Sion.
Shout, O daughters of Jerusalem.
Juig, O dogters van Jerusalem.
Behold, thy king cometh unto thee.
Kyk, jou koning kom na jou.
He is just, having salvation.
Regverdig, 'n oorwinnaar is hy.
Lowly, and riding upon an ass, upon the foal, a colt, the foal of an ass.
Nederig, en ry op 'n esel, op 'n foal, a young esel, die foal van 'n eselin.
Now, what was the matter with those scribes?
Nou, wat was die probleem met daardie skrifgeleerdes?
What was the matter with those priests?
Wat was die probleem met daardie priesters?
What was the matter with those priests?
Wat was die probleem met daardie priesters?
What was the matter with those religious people?
Wat was die probleem met daardie godsdienstige mense?
This was wrote 487 years before it happened.
Hierdie was geskryf 487 jaar voor dit gebeur het.
By a vindicated prophet.
Deur 'n bevestigde profeet.
And was already put into writings and called the Bible. The scrolls of the Old Testament.
En was alreeds in die geskrifte geplaas en die Bybel genoem. Die boekrolle van die Ou Testament.
Why couldn't they see that that's prophecy being fulfilled?
Hoekom kon hulle nie sien dat daardie profesie was wat vervul word nie?
The same reason they can't see it today.
Dieselfde rede waarom hulle dit nie vandag kan sien nie.
They took the word of God and made it of none effect to the people by teaching for traditions, for doctrine, the traditions of man.
Hulle het die woord van God geneem en dit kragteloos gemaak aan die mense deur die leer van oorleweringe, van doktrines, die tradisie van die mens.
And if scribes, preachers, ministers, spiritual men so-called, anointed ones, would only read the Bible, they wouldn't be wondering what's taking place. They would know what it is.
En as skrifgeleerde, predikers, leraars, geestelike manne, sogenaamd, gesalfdes, net die Bybel sou lees, sou hulle nie wonder wat plaasvind nie, hulle sou weet wat dit is.
God, fulfilling His word.
God, wat sy woord vervul.
History was being made. Prophecy was being fulfilled.
Geskiedenis is gemaak. Profesie is vervul.
Salvation to the world was arriving.
Verlossing het gearriveer vir die wêreld.
The great day that all the prophets had looked forward to.
Die groot dag waarna al die profete uitgesien het.
All that was in the grave was waiting for that day.
Almal wat in die graf was, het gewag vir daardie dag.
Think of it.
Goeiste. Dink daaraan.
All that had died. All the righteous of the blood of the martyrs and the prophets.
Almal wat gesterf het. Al die regverdiges van die bloed van die martelare en die profete.
But you just screamed out, Jerusalem, oh Jerusalem.
Wat het pas uitgeskree? Jerusalem, wo Jerusalem.
You that stone every prophet that ascend to you and kill the righteous.
Jy wat elke profeet stenig wat ek vir jou gestuur het en die regverdiges doodgemaak het.
How oft would I have hovered you as a hen that would have brooded, but you would not. But now, your hour's come.
Hoe dikwils sou ek jou onder my vlerke wil neem soos a hen haar kuikens, maar jy wou nie. Maar nou het jou uur aangebreek.
Everything that was in the grave, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, all the prophets were waiting for this hour.
Alles wat in die graf was, Abraham, Isaac, Jakob, al die profete het gewag vir hierdie uur.
And the church was blind to it.
En die kerk was blind daarvoor.
Who is this? Cause all this noise.
Wie is hierdie wat al hierdie geraas maak?
Who is that fellow that said one time, is not that the carpenter's son over here?
Wie is daar die kerel? Hulle het een keer gesê. Is daar nie die skrynwerkers se seun daar oorkant nie?
We know him.
Ons ken hom.
Where did he get this wisdom?
Waar het hy daardie wysheid gekry?
Well, we don't seem connected with any of our schools.
Doch, ons sien hom nie verbind met enige van ons skole nie.
We don't know any books he ever learned from.
Ons weet nie van enige boeke waar het hy ooit geleer het nie.
Who is it?
Wie is dit?
He was the answer of the prophet's prophecy.
Hy was die antwoord op die profeet se profesie.
Here he comes, riding upon the foal of an ass.
Hier kom hy, aan die ry op die vol van die eselen.
What an attraction!
Wat aantrekkingskrag!
God was fulfilling his promised word, the hour that had been waiting since 4,000 years.
God was sy beloofde woord aan die vervul, die uur waarvoor gewag was vanaf 4,000 jaar.
And Genesis, the 3rd chapter and the 15th verse, God had made the prediction.
In Genesis, die 3rde hoofstuk en die 15e vers, het God die voorspelling gemaakt.
The seed of the woman shall bruise the serpent's head, but his head shall bruise her heel.
Die saad van die vrou sal die slang se kop vermorsel, maar sy kop sal haar in die hakskin byt.
That prophecy down through the Bible that had been predicted of this man coming.
Daar die profesie, reg af deur die Bybel, wat voorspel het van hierdie man wat sou kom.
Here, just recently, there was a prophet who stood up among them that was vindicated the prophet, Zechariah, and he said that...
En hier, net onlangs, was daar een profeet wat onder hulle opgestaan het, wat een bevestigde profeet was, Zechariah, en het gesê dat...
You daughters of Jerusalem and you daughters of Zion, rejoice, shout, scream out!
Julle dogters van Jerusalem en julle dogters van Sion, juig, skree uit.
For your king comes to you, meek and lowly and humble, riding upon the foal of an ass.
Want julle koning kom na julle, sagmoedig en saghart en nederig, en ry op die foal van 'n eselin.
And here those people that read that scripture day by day, watched him come riding in and cried, who is this?
En hier staan daar die mense wat daar die skrif gelees het, dag vir dag, en gekyk hoe hy ingery kom en geroep, wie is hierdie? Sien?
God fulfilling his word to the people that should have known what it was, but they didn't know it.
God wat sy woord vervul aan die mense, wat moes geweet het wat het was, maar hulle het dit nie geweet nie.
When God fulfills his word, it always causes an attraction. Always does.
Wanneer God sy woord vervul, veroorsaak dit altyd 'n aantrekkingskrag. Altyd.
Causes an attraction. For it is the unusual.
Veroorsaak 'n aantrekkingskrag, want dit is die ongewone.
So unusual when he fulfills his word to the modern trend of the day.
So ongewoon. Wanneer hy sy woord vervul aan die moderne gang van die dag.
Because the modern trend of the day don't believe in it. They have their own way.
Want die moderne gang van die dag glo nie daarin nie. Hy het hulle eie weg.
Now, we see and let us go back in the scriptures and take some other unusual events. Just for a few more minutes. When God fulfilled his prophecy.
Nou, ons sien en laat ons teruggaan in die skrif en 'n paar ander ongewone gebeurtenisse neem net vir nog 'n paar minute wanneer God sy profesie vervul het.
When God says anything, he's going to do it.
Wanneer God enigiets sê, gaan hy dit doen.
All heavens and earth will pass away, but that word can never pass away.
Al die hemele en aarde sal verbygaan, maar daardie woord kan nooit verbygaan nie.
So, it usually causes a scene, an unusual scene.
So, dit veroorsaak gewoonlik 'n skouspel, 'n ongewone skouspel.
Notice how ridiculous that the word of God to a people who's supposed to believe it and yet it's so unusual they cry, well, what's this?
Let op, hoe belaglik dat die woord van God aan 'n volk wat veronderstel is om dit te glo, en toch is dit so ongewoon dat hulle uitroep, wel, wat is dit?
Where'd you get that stuff? Who is this? What is this?
Waar kry julle daardie goed? Wie is hierdie? Wat is hierdie?
When they ought to have been screaming, Hosanna! To the king that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Wanneer hulle behoort te geskree het, Hosanna aan die koning wat kom in die naam van die Here.
But there's just a little group doing that. Just a little group.
Maar daar was net 'n klein groepie wat dit gedoen het. Net 'n klein groepie.
About 4,000 years of prophecy for the greatest thing that could ever happen to the nation.
Van 4,000 jaar van profesie. Van die grootste ding wat ooit kon gebeur met die volk.
For all the hope of the dead rested upon it.
Want al die hoop van die dooies het daarop gerus.
All the future laid in it.
Die hele toekoms het daarin gelê.
And the religious people that claimed they believe it was screaming out, who is it?
En die godsdienstige mense wat aanspraak gemaak het dat hulle dit geglooi het, het uitgeskree, wie is dit?
What's this attraction?
En wat is hier die aantrekkingskrag?
Something unusual.
It's ongewoons.
Not the same. Just don't change. Not unusual.
Omtrent dieselfde. Dit verander net nie. Nou ongewoon.
Let's see some of the unusual things as I just said.
Laat ons nou 'n paar van die ongewone dinge kyk, soos ek pas gesê het.
What was the attraction just before judgment struck the world and destroyed it by water?
Wat was die aantrekkingskrag net voor oordeel die wêreld getref het en dit deur water vernietig het?
An old man, around 120 years old, building a boat when there was no water to float it in.
'N ou man, om en by 120 jaar oud, wat 'n boot gebou het, toe daar geen water was om dit in te laat dryf nie.
Up there for years, standing in the door, building away on the interior, on the inside, and pitching it, inside and out.
Daar bo vir jare, in die deur gestaan, gebou aan die binnenhuis, aan die binnenkant, en het binnen en buiten verdig met pik.
Say the world's going to be swallowed up with water. The great scientific age.
En sê, die wêreld gaan ingesluk word met water. Die groot wetenskaplike eeuw.
What is that pounding up on the hill up there?
Wat is die gehamer daar bo op die heuwel?
Why is an old man by the name of Noah? And he's up there, the old fanatic.
Wat, dis 'n ou man met die naam van Noah. En hy is daar bo, 'n ou fanaticus.
The old man stood in the sun too long. He's sunstroked.
Die ou man het te lank in die son gestaan. Hy het sonsteek.
He's out of his mind.
Hy is van sy verstand af.
And he's building what he calls an ark. And saying waters is coming from up there where there is no water. And it's going to float all the people around.
En hy bou wat hy noem 'n ark. En sy waters gaan van daar bo af kom waar daar geen water is nie. En dit gaan al die mense rond laat dryf.
And everybody that don't hear his message, and everybody that won't come into that ark, is going to be drowned.
En almal wat nie na sy boodskap luister nie, en almal wat nie in daardie ark wil ingaan nie, gaan verdrink word.
Did you ever hear such a thing? It was an unusual attraction.
Het jy ooit van so iets gehoor? Dit was 'n ongewone aantrekkingskrag.
I imagine when the people want a good laugh, they went up and stood before the ark door and laughed.
Ek reken wanneer die mense lekker wou lag, het hulle soontoe gegaan en voor die ark deur gestaan en gelag.
Why, you said it was going to rain 100 years ago.
Toch, jy het gesê dit gaan reën 100 jaar gelede.
Grandpa told me he heard you up here saying it's going to rain.
Oupa het vir my gesê hy het jou hierbo hoor sê dit gaan reën.
And you're still beating around on this old piece of wood up here.
En jy kap nog steeds aan hierdie ou stuk hout hierbo.
Why don't you get next to yourself?
Hoekom kom jy nie reg nie?
But it was God. Get ready to confirm a promise and to fulfill a prophecy that his prophet had made.
Maar God was gereed om 'n belofte te vervul en om 'n profesie te vervul wat sy profeet gemaak het.
Very unusual.
Baie ongewoon.
God fulfilling his promise to Noah. While others was laughing.
God, wat sy belofte aan Noag vervul het, terwyl andere gelag het.
God was also getting ready to make history. To show to others, even to this day, that he keeps his word.
Word het ook gereed gemaak om geskiedenis te maak, om andere te wys, selfs tot by hierdie dag, dat hy sy woord hou.
No matter how unreal it seems unreasonable, he still keeps his word.
Maak nie saak hoe onwerklik dit blyk te wees en onredelik nie. Hy hou steeds sy woord.
He was making an example out of that old man pounding on that ark for these people here in America tonight and all over the world.
Hy het 'n voorbeeld gemaak uit daardie ou man wat aan daardie ark kap vir hierdie mense hier in Amerika vanaand en reg oor die wêreld.
No matter what science says, what they say, this, that, or the other, he still keeps his word. He was making history.
Maak nie saak wat wetenskap sê nie, wat hulle sê, dit, dat, of die ander nie. Hy hou steeds sy woord. Hy het geskiedenis gemaak.
What was the attraction one day? An unusual thing happened back in the wilderness. And it was a bush that was on fire.
Wat was die aantrekkingskrag eendag? 'N Ongewone ding het gebeur agter in die wildernis. En dit was 'n bos wat aan die brand was.
And a runaway prophet was standing down in the wilderness.
En 'n weghardloop profeet het gestaan onder in die wildernis.
He never heard no voice. He never heard no sound. But he looked and seen an unusual thing up on top of the mountain.
Hy het nooit enige stem gehoor nie. Hy het nooit enige geluid gehoor nie, maar het gekyk en 'n ongewone ding bo op die berg gesien.
God was trying to attract his attention.
God wou sy aandag trek.
Same is it today.
Dieselfde is dit vandag.
God was getting ready to fulfill his word by his prophet Abraham.
God was gereed om sy woord te vervul. Dis sy profeet Abraham.
Your seeds, your sojourn 400 years in a strange land, I'll bring them out with a mighty hand.
Jou saad sal vir 400 jaar vertoef in 'n vreemde land. Ek sal hulle uitbring met 'n magtige hand.
And he was preparing a man for the job as he was preparing an ark for a safety place for all who would believe.
En hy was 'n man aan die voorberei vir die werk. Soos hy 'n ark voorberei het vir 'n veilige plek vir almal wat wil glo.
God put this bush on fire. And this sheep herder, Moses, said, I will just turn aside to see what this strange thing means.
God het hierdie bos aan die brand gesteek. En hierdie skaapwagter, Moses, het gesê, ek sal net afdraai om te kyk wat hierdie vreemde ding beteken.
And when he got Moses up to the bush, he spoke to him.
En toe hy Moses bo by die bos kry, het hy met hom gepraat.
What was the attraction later in the pilot's hall when this sheep herder threw down a stick and it turned into a serpent?
Wat was die aantrekkingskrag later in die Pilatus se saal toe hierdie skaapwagter 'n stok neergegooi het? En dit in 'n slang verander het.
God fulfilling his promise to Moses.
God wat sy belofte vervul aan Moses.
What was the attraction at the Dead Sea? When Pharaoh's horses was all astonished.
Wat was die aantrekkingskrag by die dooie see? Toe Farao se perde almal verskrik was.
When they seen a wind come down from the heavens and part the Red Sea from right to left.
Toe hulle 'n wind sien opkom uit die hemel en die Rooi See van links na regs verdeel.
And a poor bunch of slaves walking in the duty of God walk across that on dry land.
En 'n arme klomp slawe wat in die plig van God wandel, daar oorloop op droë land.
What was it? God keeping his word.
Wat was dit? God wat sy woord hou.
The deadness moved away. A living people went across.
Die doodsheid het wegbeweeg. 'N Lewende volk het oorgegaan.
And a spiritually dead people tried to impersonate it and drowned it.
En 'n geestelike dooie volk het dit probeer naboots en verdrink.
God fulfilling prophecy and making history.
God wat profesie vervul en geskiedenis maak.
That was the attraction at the Dead Sea.
Dit was die aantrekkingskrag by die dooie see.
What was the attraction the second day after that? At Mount Sinai.
Wat was die aantrekkingskrag die tweede dag daarna? By berg Sinai.
When all the people was commanded not to come at their wives.
toe die hele volk beveel was om nie by hulle vroue te kom nie.
When they asked to wash your clothes and sanctify themselves and gather around the mountain.
Toe hulle gevra is om hulle klere te was en hulle self te reinig en rondom 'n berg by mekaar te kom.
Where a man by the name of Moses had said he met God in a pillar of fire.
Waar 'n man met die naam van Moses gesê het, hy het God in 'n vuurkolom ontmoet.
And God had said to Moses, I'm going to come down amongst the people.
En God het vir Moses gesê, ek gaan afkom onder die mense.
I'm going to confirm that what I told you and who I am, I'm going to show them that I am that God.
Ek gaan bevestig dit wat ek vir jou gesê het en wie ek is. Ek gaan hulle wys dat ek daardie God is.
That was attraction. God fulfilling his word.
Dit was die aantrekkingskrag. God wat sy woord vervul.
What was the attraction one day in history where a nation had forgot God?
Wat was die aantrekkingskrag eendag in die geskiedenis waar 'n volk God vergeet het?
Where the people had become formal and indifferent.
Waar die mense formeel en onverskillig geword het.
Where the priests had all went with the modern trend.
Waar die priesters almal saam in die moderne gang gegaan het.
The prophets prophesied according to the will of the priest.
Die profete geprofeteer het volgens die wil van die priesters.
In that day, as usual, they had one man that they thought was a fanatic.
En in daardie dag, soos gewoonlik, het hulle een man gehad wat hulle gedink het 'n fanatikus was.
He talked about women wearing paint and everything, and he was a kind of an odd sort of a guy.
Hy het gepraat van vroue wat verf dra en alles, en hy was soort van 'n snaakse soort van 'n kerel.
And this old fellow had come down and said to the king, not even dues go to call, come until I call for it.
En hierdie ou kerel het afgekom en vir die koning gesê, nie eens dou gaan vir, kom, totdat ek daarvoor vra nie.
And we find out then that he had hid himself and run away from it. And he hid out in the wilderness somewhere.
En ons vind uit, toe dat hy homself versteek het, en weggehardloop het daarvan, en weggekruip het in die wildernis iewers.
The company thought that maybe he had starved to death or perished.
Die geselskap het gedink dat hy miskien gesterf het van die honger of vergaan het.
But he had been fed pretty well. Water too.
Maar hy was baie goed gevoed. En water gegee ook.
And here he was. Come down. And said, do you see that I have thus saith the Lord?
En hier was hy. Afgekom en gesê, sien julle dat ek so spreek die Here het?
Now, if you're not convinced yet, let's go up to the top of the mountain and prove who's God.
Nou, as julle nog nie oortuig is nie, laat ons opgaan na die top van die berg en bewys wie God is.
For he had another vision from the Lord.
Want hy het nog 'n visioen van die Here gehad.
He said, choose you a altar and make it and choose ox and slay him.
Hy het gesê, kies vir julle 'n altaar en maak dit en kies os en slag hulle.
I'll make an altar of the Lord and also I will put ox on mine.
Ek sal 'n altaar bou vir die Here en sal ook 'n os op myne sit.
We'll both make a sacrifice and let the God that's God answer.
Ons sal albei 'n offer maak en laat die God wat God is beantwoord.
He had by no means done that if the Lord hadn't told him. He said so later.
Hy sou dit onder geen omstandighede gedoen het as Here hom nie gesê het om dit te doen nie. Hy het later so gesê.
I've done this and all this at your command, Lord.
Ek het dit gedoen volgens dit alles volgens u bevel, Here.
But what's the attraction?
Maar wat is die aantrekkingskrag?
It's got 400 priests standing on the hill. And the king up there in his chariot with all of his armors and guards standing around.
Dit het 400 priesters op die heuwel laat staan en die koning daarbo in sy strydwa met al sy wapenrustings en wagte wat rond staan.
And this all woolly, fuzzy face looking man, bald head and hairs hanging down over his face.
En hierdie ou wonderige dons gesig man, kaal kop en hare wat afhang oor sy gesig.
Piece of sheepskin draped around him, hairs all over his body, standing up there with a stick in his hand, a cruse oil in the other hand.
Stuk skaafvel om hom gedraai en hare oor sy hele liggaam, wat daar bo staan met 'n stok in sy hand en 'n kruik olie in die ander hand.
They just said 3 years and a half before that not even dew will fall till I call from it. Fart.
Wat pas gesê het, 3.5 jaar tevore, nie een dou sal val voor ek daarvoor vra, daarvoor nie.
Taking the place of God with such things as halos and shatters and all they talk about.
Die plek van God ingeneem, met sulke goed soos stralekranse en skaduwees en alles waaroor hulle praat.
And here that old fanatic standing up there on the hill, bringing all these people up there.
En hier staan daar die ou fanaticus daar bo op die heuwel. En bring al daar die mens soontoe.
What was that attraction?
Wat was daar die aantrekkingskrag?
It was God. Fixing to vindicate his prophet to be right.
Dit was God. Wat gereed was om sy profeet as reg te bewys.
It was God. Fulfilling prophecy.
Dit was God. Wat profesie vervul het.
God. Also making history. Fulfilling the word.
God. Wat ook geskiedenis gemaak het, die woord vervul het.
A few hundred years after that, there was a man anointed with that same spirit.
Paar honderd jaar daarna, was daar 'n man gesalf met daar dieselfde gees.
And he come out of the wilderness. Not connected with any organization, so his daddy was an organization man. A priest of an order.
En hy het uit die wildernis gekom, nie verbind met enige organisasies nie. Hoewel sy pa 'n organisasieman was, 'n priester van 'n orde.
But he come out of the wilderness, dressed with a sheepskin around him.
Maar hy het uit die wildernis gekom, aangetrek met 'n skaapvel oor hom.
Hair all over his face, instead of being gray, it was black.
Hare oor sy hele gesig, in plaas van grys te wees, was dit swart.
What was this man's attraction that attracted all Jerusalem and Judea?
Wat was hierdie man se aantrekkingskrag? Wat die hele Jerusalem en Judea aangetrek het.
Some of them going out said there's a wild man down there. He's trying to drown the people in water. Who ever heard of such a thing as that?
Party van hulle wat uitgegaan en gesê het, daar is 'n wilde man daaronder. Hy probeer die mense in die water verdrink. Wie weet van so iets was dit gehoor.
Others were curious and saying this must be the Messiah.
Ander was nieuwsgierig en het gesê, hierdie moet die Messias wees.
One of them said it could be one of the prophets.
Een van hulle het gesê, dit kon een van die profete wees.
They didn't know what to think.
Hulle het nie geweet wat om te dink nie.
But what was it?
Maar wat was dit?
It was God. Fulfilling Isaiah 40.
Dit was God. Wat Jesaja 40 vervul het.
Where he said, behold, what he would do in the last days. How he would send his servant. What he would do.
Waar hy gesê het, kyk, wat in die laaste dae sou doen. Hoe hy sy dienaar sou stuur en wat hy sou doen.
Then we find a few weeks after that, that man being so positive of his message, till he said,
dan vind ons 'n paar weke daarna, dat daardie man so oortuig was van sy boodskap, totdat hy gesê het,
there's one standing in among you, whose shoes I'm not worthy to bear.
Daar is een wat onder julle staan, wie se skoene ek nie werd is om te dra nie.
He will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire, as I baptize you with water.
Hy sal julle doop met die Heilige Gees en vuur, soos ek gedoop het met water.
One day an ordinary young man, about 30 years old, walked down and was baptized.
Eendag het 'n gewone jong man, omtrent 30 jaar, afgeloop en is gedoop.
And when this man come, there was such an attraction by the prophet.
En toe hier die man kom, was daar so 'n aantrekkingskrag by die profeet?
The prophet act strange that day.
Die profeet het snaaks opgetree daardie dag.
The congregation couldn't help from watching the action of that prophet. When he was debating with the priest across the river.
Die gemeente kon nie help om die aksie van die profeet dop te hou. Toe hy met die priesters oor kan die rivier gedebatteer het nie.
They said, God built this altar. God told us to do this.
Hy het gesê, God het hier die altaar gebou. God het vir ons gesê om dit te doen.
Moses is the prophet. We believe Moses. The sacrifice will never be done away with.
Moses is die profeet. Ons glo Moses. Daar sal nooit weggedoen word met die offer nie.
I can hear John answer back. Said, have not you read in the scripture what Daniel the prophet said?
Ek kan Johannes woord terug antwoord, het gesê, Het julle nie in die skrif gelees waar Daniel die profeet gesê het?
The daily sacrifice will be done away with.
Daar sal weggedoen word met die daglikse offerande nie.
That hour has arrived.
En daar die uur het aangebreek.
Have not you read what Isaiah said in the 40th chapter?
Het julle nie gelees wat Jesaja gesê het in die 40ste hoofstuk?
The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord.
Die stem van die een wat roep in die woestijn, berei die weg van die Here nie.
There's two prophecies for me.
Daar is twee profetieë vir my.
And another thing. Did not you recognize our prophet 400 years ago, Malachi?
En nog een ding. Het julle nie ons profeet herken 400 jaar gelede, Malachi?
When he spoke in the third chapter, said, Behold, I send my messenger before my face to prepare the way.
Toe in die derde hoofstuk gesprek en gesê, kyk, ek stuur my boodskapper voor my aangesig uit om die weg voor te berei nie.
Don't you know this fulfills prophecy? Prophecy was being fulfilled.
Weet julle nie hierdie verval profesie nie? Profesie is verval.
And about that time, the prophet turned and said, Behold, there comes the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world.
En omtrent daar die tyd het die profeet omgedraai en gesê, kyk, daar kom die lam van God wat die sonde van die wêreld wegneem.
Now what's the attraction?
Nou, wat's die aantrekkingskrag?
It's changed from the prophet to his prophecy.
Dit het verander van die profeet na sy profesie.
Now notice what comes to pass.
Nou let op wat gebeur.
Here comes an ordinary man, known of no one, a carpenter's son. Come walking out in the water.
Hier kom 'n gewone man, bekend aan niemand, 'n skrynwerker se seun, uitgestap in die water.
When John the great prophet said, I have need to be baptized with thee, why comest thou to me?
Toe Johannes die groot profeet gesê het, ek het nodig dat u my doop, hoekom kom u na my?
He said, suffer that to be so, but as a prophet and the word, it behooves us to fulfill all righteousness.
Hy het gesê, laat dit so wees, maar as 'n profeet en die woord, moet ons alle geregtigheid vervul.
So he understood the sacrifice had to be washed before presented, and he baptized him.
So hy het verstaan, die offer moet gewas word, voordat aangebied word, en hy het hom gedoop.
Now, there's another attraction takes place. When he went up out of the water.
Nou, daar's 'n ander aantrekkingskrag wat plaasgevind het. Toe ooit die water opgestaan het.
This prophet who had been so loyal to declare his age and the time.
Heer die profeet wat so getrou was om sy eeuw en die tyd te verklaar.
He looked up and he saw the heavens open.
Hy het opgekyk en die hemel gesien oopgaan.
He saw the spirit of God like a dove descending upon him.
Hy het die gees van God gesien soos 'n duif wat op hom neerdal.
And a voice saying, This is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased.
En 'n stem wat sê, dit is my geliefde seun in wie ek welbehaag het.
God was vindicating a prophet's message what was attracting the attention at the Jordan.
God het die profeet se boodskap bevestig wat die aandag getrek het by die Jordaan.
A brother sang a while ago, he was supposed to sing. On the hills far away stood an old rugged cross.
'N broer het 'n tyd gelede gesing, of hy was veronderstel om te sing. Op die heuwels ver van hier staan 'n ou ruwe kruis.
What's the attraction on Mount Calvary?
Wat is die aantrekkingskrag op Golgotha berg?
When we see the religious world had condemned him and the Roman government had sentenced him to death.
Wanneer ons sien, die godsdienstige wêreld het hom veroordeel. En die Romeinse regering het hom tot dood veroordeel.
And here he was, hanging between two malefactors, starving for a drink, blood running out of his body.
En hier het hy gehang, tussen twee misdadigers, dood van die dors, bloed wat uit sy liggaam vloei.
There he hangs, crying, My God! My God, why has thou forsaken me?
Daar hang hy, aan die uitroep, My God, waarom het u my verlaat?
And the religious people standing there looking at it.
En de godsdienstige mensen, wat er staan, wat daar naar kijk.
Little did they know that the prophecy of the Old Testament was being met right there at Calvary that time.
Men het hulle geweet dat die profetie van die Oude Testament net daar bij Golgotha vervul was op daar die tijdstip.
David himself wrote, I fell into the spirit like all prophets. He act like it was him.
David het self geskryf, gemaakt in die geest verval, soos al die profete het gemaakt as het hy was.
David cried in the 22nd Psalm, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?
David het geroep in die 22ste Psalm, my God, waarom het u my verlaat?
All my bones, they stare at me.
Al my bene, hulle staar na my.
They pierce my hands and my feet.
Hulle het my hande en my voete deurboor.
David speaking like it was him.
David wat praat asof dit hy was.
And it wasn't David, it was Christ in David.
En dit was nie David nie, dit was Christus in David.
And yet the very prophecy that went forth of all the different prophets was being fulfilled on Mount Calvary.
En hier is die eenste profetie wat uitgegaan het van al die verskillende profete vervul op Golgotha berg.
What's the attraction on Mount Calvary? God fulfilling his word.
Wat is die aantrekkingskrag op Golgotha berg? God wat sy woord vervul.
Another attraction was on the mount. Was on the day of Pentecost.
Nog 'n aantrekkingskrag wat op 'n berg was, was op die Pinksterdag.
When all of them was up there in religious feast, thought they got rid of all the fanatics.
Toe hulle almal daar bo was in 'n godsdienstige fees, gedink het hulle het ontslaag raak van al die fanatici.
They hadn't heard from them for 10 days.
Hulle het nie van hulle gehoor vir 10 dae nie.
All of a sudden, like a beehive, they broke out of the top of the building.
Meteens kom daar soos 'n bijekorf, het hulle uitgebreek aan die bokant van die gebou.
Out into the streets of screaming and carrying on.
Uit in die strate aan die skree en die aangaan.
What is this? What meaneth this? Are all these men drunk?
Wat is hierdie? Wat beteken dit? Is al hierdie mense dronk?
Watch!
Kijk!
And a prophet stood up among them, as the order of a prophet should be.
En 'n profeet het tussen hulle gestaan, soos die orde van 'n profeet moet wees.
He said, ye men of Israel, and you that dwell in Judea, in Jerusalem, let this be known unto you and hearken to my words.
En gesê, hele manne van Israel, en hele wat woon in Judea, in Jerusalem, laat het bekend word aan hele, en luister na my woorde.
These are not drunk like you think they are, but this is that. Which is spoken of by the Lord to Joel the prophet.
Diegene is nie dronk soos jy dink hulle is nie, maar dit is wat gespreek is deur die Here, deur Joel die profeet.
It shall come to pass in the last days, I'll pour out my spirit upon all flesh.
Dit sal gebeur in die laaste dae, dat ek my gees sal uitstort op alle vlees.
That was the attraction.
Dit was die aantrekkingskrag.
The religious people, after crucifying the Prince of Life and everything, still didn't see the promise of the coming of the Holy Spirit.
Die godsdienstige mense, nadat hulle die Prins van die Lewe gekruisig het en alles, het steeds nie die belofte van die koms van die Heilige Gees gesien nie.
The attraction, who is this? What meaneth this? What's the matter with them people?
Die aantrekkingskrag, wie is hierdie? Wat beteken dit? Wat is die probleem met hierdie mense?
Oh my, it's the same today.
Wow, goeieste, dit is dieselfde vandag.
We'll bypass a lot of this to bring it to this hour.
Ons sal by baie hiervan voorbygaan, om dit na hierdie uur te bring.
The same thing is today.
Dieselfde ding is vandag.
The same thing is taking place, the same questions asked.
Dieselfde ding vind plaas, dieselfde vraag word gevra.
What's all that racket?
Wat is al daar die geraas?
Look up and down the street. Cars from Michigan, Florida, from Maine to California.
Kijk op en af in die straat. Motors van Michigan tot Florida, van Maine tot California.
This morning when I was riding out right afternoon, was going down the street. Wife and I was looking at license on cars. That's where I thought of this text.
Vanmorgen, toe ek uitgery het, of net na middag, het ons by die straat afgegaan, het ek en my vrou na die nommerplate op die motors gekyk. Dis waar ek gedink het aan hierdie tekst.
What means this?
Wat beteken dit?
Just as it said, where the carcass is, there the eagles will gather.
Net soos dit gesê het, waar die karkas is, daar sal die arende vergader.
I said to my wife, honey, you remember the last night? When I had to say goodbye to everything was dear to me on earth and go into the fields to start something that God had said do.
Ek het vir my vrou gesê, skat, onthou jy die laaste aand, toe ek moes tot sien sê vir alles wat so dierbaar was vir my op aarde en in die velde ingaan om iets te begin wat God gesê het om te doen.
You sing that song, oh, they'll come from the east and the west.
Jy het daar die lied gesing, oh, hulle kom van die ooste en die weste.
They come from the lands afar.
Hulle kom van die ver af lande.
To feast with our king, to dine as his guest.
Feest te vier saam met ons koning, te eet as sy gas.
How blessed these pilgrims are.
Hoe geseend is hier die pelgrims.
Beholding his hallowed face, aglow with love divine.
Ten aanskoue van sy heilige gesig, skynende met goddelike liefde.
Blessed partakers of his grace, and gems in his crown will shine.
Geseende deelgenote van sy genade, as juwele in sy kroon te skyn.
That's what the attraction is.
Dis wat die aantrekkingskrag is.
The predestinated seed of God who can't do nothing else but follow it.
Die voorbestemde saad van God wat niks anders kan doen as om dit te volg nie.
Means more than life to us.
Beteken meer as lewe vir ons.
Take our lives, but you don't take that.
Neem ons levens, maar jylle kan dit nie neem nie.
What is the attraction?
Wat is die aantrekkingskrag?
God as usual, fulfilling his word.
God soos gewoontlik, wat sy woord vervul.
He's fulfilling the word of Zechariah. Again, the prophet Zechariah.
Hy vervul weer die woord van Zechariah, van profeet Zechariah.
We read the ninth verse a while ago, when Jesus entered his temple, entered Jerusalem, riding on a little white donkey.
Waar ek die neende vers een tyd gelede gelees het, toe Jesus sy tempel binnengegaan het, gery het, of Jerusalem binnengegaan het, gery het op een klein wit donkey.
The prophecy was fulfilled that Zechariah said,
is die profetie vervul wat Zechariah gesê het?
Here it is, rejoice greatly, O daughters of Zion, shout, O daughters of Jerusalem.
Hier is dit. Verjuig, jou grootliks, O dochters van Sion. Juig, O dochters van Jerusalem.
Behold, our king is coming unto thee.
Kijk, jylle koning, kom na jylle.
He is just and having salvation, lowly riding upon an ass and upon the colt, the foal of an ass.
Hy is rechtvaardig en met verlossing, nederig. Ry op een esel en op een jong esel die vol van die eselin.
That's what the attraction was at Jerusalem, at the religious headquarters.
Dis wat die aantrekkingskrag was by Jerusalem, by die godsdienstige hoofkwartiere.
Now, we see a last day happening.
Nou, sien ons een laaste dag gebeurtenis.
Let's just turn a few pages on in Zechariah and see what he said about it.
Laat ons net een paar blaaie aanblaai in Zechariah en kyk wat hy daarvan gesê het.
Let's turn over then for the last days.
Laat ons het dan oorblaai vir die laaste dag.
That was the middle age. Let's turn now to the last days.
Daardie was die middeleeuw. Laat ons nou blaai na die laaste dag.
And turn over to Zechariah, the 14th chapter. And beginning with the 4th verse and listen.
En blaai oor na Zechariah, die 14e hoofstuk. En vanaf die 4de vers. En luister.
And we're going to read down a portion of the scripture, about 9 verses, from 4 to 9. Listen close.
En ons gaan een deel van die skrif onder toe lees, omtrent 9 verse, van 4 tot 9. Luister aandachtig.
And it's prophesying of his coming, the last days. Listen close now.
En het profeteer van sy komst, die laaste dag. Luister nou aandachtig.
This is thus saith the Lord, it's the scripture, Zechariah 14.
Hierdie is so spreek die Heere, dis die skrifte, Zachariah 14.
Remember Zechariah 9, what it said? And they didn't recognize it.
Onthou Zachariah 9, wat het gesê het, en hulle het dit nie herken nie.
Now what is it today, Zechariah 14? Speaking of his coming.
Nou wat is dit vandag, Zachariah 14, wat praat van sy koms?
And his feet shall stand in that day upon the Mount of Olives again.
En in die dag sal sy voete staan op die Olijfberg weer.
Which is before Jerusalem, on the east.
Wat voor Jerusalem lê, aan die ooste kant.
On the Mount of Olives shall cleave in the midst thereof towards the east and towards the west.
Op die Olijfberg sal middeldeer gesplit word van oos na wes.
And there shall be a very great valley.
Tot 'n baie groot dal.
Half of the mountain shall be moved towards the north and half towards the south.
Die een helfte van die berg sal wegwyk na die noorde en die ander helfte na die suide.
And ye shall flee to the valley of the mountains.
En julle sal vlug in die dal van my berge.
For the valley of the mountains shall reach from Azal.
Want die dal van die berge sal loop vanaf Asal.
Yea, ye shall flee like you fled in the days of the earthquake, in the days of Uzziah, the king of Judah.
En julle sal vlug, soos julle gevlug het, vir die aardbewing, in die dae van Isia, die koning van Juda.
Another earthquake, splitting open the earth.
Nog aardbewing, wat die aarde opkloof.
If you want to follow out a scripture here, notice in this fifth verse, it applies that the cleaving of the Mount of Olives is due to an earthquake.
As julle skrif wil deurvolg hier, let op in die vijfde vers, wys dit dat die splitsing van die Olijfberg die gevolg is van 'n aardbewing.
And this is confirmed by Isaiah 29:6 and Revelation 16:9.
En dit word bevestig deur Jesaja 29:6 en Openbaring 16:9.
Exactly, what is it?
Precies, wat is dit?
The same prophet told of his first coming, seen his second coming.
Dieselfde profeet wat vertel het van sy eerste koms, het sy tweede koms gesien.
Notice, as in the days of the earthquake.
Let op, soos in die dae van die aardbewing.
See what the earthquakes are doing, see the predictions of them.
Sien wat die aardbewings doen, sien die voorspellings daarvan.
And the Lord your God shall come, and all of his saints with thee.
Dan sal die Here my God kom, al die heiliges met u.
And it shall come to pass in that day. Hallelujah.
En in die dag. Hallelujah.
In that day the light shall not be clear or dark.
In die dag sal er geen lig wees nie. Die sterre sal duister wees.
But it shall be one day which shall be known to the Lord, not day nor night.
En dit sal enige dag wees met enige dag wees wat aan die Here bekend is, geen dag en geen nag nie.
But it shall come to pass that in the evening time it shall be light. Oh God.
Maar teen die aandtyd sal dit lig word. O God.
It shall be light about the evening time.
Dit sal lig word teen die aandtyd.
Same prophet. And the people is blind.
Selfde profeet en die mense is blind.
What's the attraction?
Wat is die aantrekkingskrag?
Let's read a couple more verses.
Laat ons nog 'n paar verse lees.
And it shall be in that day that the living water shall go forth from Jerusalem.
En in die dag sal daar die lewende waters uit Jerusalem uitvloei.
Half of them towards the former sea and half towards the hinder sea.
Die een helfte daarvan na die oostelike en die ander helfte na die westelike see.
In the summer and winter shall it be, the gospel going forth both Jew and Gentile.
Die somer en winter sal dit so wees, die evangelie wat uitgaan by die Jood en Heiden.
And the Lord shall be king over the earth.
En die Here sal koning wees oor die aarde.
In that day, and there shall be one Lord. and his name one.
In die dag sal daar een Here wees en sy naam een.
It shall be light about the evening time. Right!
Dit sal lig wees in die aandtyd. Reg!
The way to glory you will surely find.
Die pad na heerlikheid sal jy beslis vind.
In the waterway is the light today.
In die waterweg is die lig vandag.
Buried in the precious name of Jesus.
Begrawe in die kosbare naam van Jesus.
Young and old, repent of all your sins.
Jonk en oud, bekeer van al jou sondes.
The Holy Ghost will surely enter in.
Die Heilige Gees sal sekerlik inkom.
The evening light has come.
Die aandlig het gekom.
It is a fact that God and Christ are one.
Dit is 'n feit dat God en Christus een is.
See where we're at?
Sien waar ons is?
Nations are breaking. Israel's awakening. The signs that our prophets foretold.
Nasies verbrokkel. Israel ontwaak. Die tekens wat ons profete voorspel het.
That earthquake to the Gentiles to the last day.
Daar die aardbewing aan die heidene aan die laaste dag.
The Gentile days numbered. With horrors encumbered.
Die heidendag getel. Met verskrikkinge omring.
Return, O dispersed, to your own.
Keer terug, O verstrooides, na jou eie.
You that's been kicked out in these arks carried on new carts. Get out of there before death strikes you.
Julle wat uitgeskop is en hierdie arke wat op nuwe waans gedra word. Kom daaruit voor die dood julle tref.
God has confirmed it. It shall be so.
God het dit bevestig. Dit sal so wees.
Let us turn over to another scripture in the Old Testament. Malachi, the fourth chapter. And read that little fourth chapter.
Laat ons oorblaai na nog 'n skrif in die Ou Testament. Malachi, die vierde hoofstuk. En daar die klein vierde hoofstuk lees.
Behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. And all the proud, yea, all that do wickedly shall be as stubbles.
Kyk, die dag kom en het brand soos 'n oond. Dan sal al die vermetelis, almal wat godloos het bedrywe, wees soos stoppels.
Now this Malachi 3 was the first coming now. Here's the next coming.
Nou, hier is nie. Dis Malachi 3 was die eerste koms. Nou hier is die volgende koms.
Even the Dr. Scofield here, I certainly don't agree with him in his footnotes, but he's got it lined out here, right?
Selfs die Dr. Scofield hier, ek stem beslis nie saam met hom in sy voetnotas nie. Maar hier het hy dit reg uitgeskryf.
The commission of John, the Malachi 3, and the second coming of Christ and Elijah beforehand.
Die opdrag van Johannes aan Malachi 3 en die tweede koms van Christus en Elia voor die tyd. Goed.
All the proud shall burn, up saith the Lord of hosts.
Al die vermetelis sal verbrand, sê die Here van die leerskare.
And it shall leave them neither root nor branch.
Sodat dit vir hulle geen wortel of tak sal oorlaat nie.
Where's the eternal hell then?
Waar is die ewige hel dan?
But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness rise. With healing campaigns, healing in his wings.
Maar vir julle wat my naam vrees, sal die son van geregtigheid opgaan. En daar sal genesingsveldtogte, genesing onder sy vleuels wees.
You shall go forth and grow up as calves of the stall.
Julle sal uittrek en huppel soos kalvers uit die stal.
And you shall tread down the wicked.
En julle sal die goddelose vertrap.
They shall be ashes under the soles of your feet in that day that I shall do this, saith the Lord of hosts.
Hulle sal so stof wees onder julle voetsole op daardie dag wat ek skep, sê die Here van die leerskare.
Remember the law of Moses, my servant, which I commanded him in Horeb, for all Israel, the statutes and judgment.
Dink aan die wet van Moses, my knig, wat ek beveel, het op Horeb vir die hele Israel, insettinge en veroordeling.
Here's the coming of Elijah.
Hier is die koms van Elia.
Behold, I will send to you Elijah the prophet.
Kyk, ek stuur aan julle die profeet Elia.
The last closing scripture of the Old Testament.
Die laaste afsluitingsskrif van die Ou Testament.
I'll send to you Elijah the prophet. before the coming of that great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Ek stuur julle die profeet Elia voor daar die groot en vreselike dag van die Here aanbreek.
And it couldn't have been John.
No, dit kon nie Johannes gewees het nie.
No, see, the world wasn't burned up, the righteous walked out on the wicked. No.
Nee, sien, die wêreld was nie verbrand en die regverdiges het nie uitgeloop op die godlose nie. Sien? Nee.
Before the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Voordat die groot en vreselike dag van die Here aanbreek.
And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the hearts of the children to the fathers, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse.
En hy sal die harte van die vaders terugbring tot die kinders, en die harte van die kinders tot die vaders, sodat ek nie hoef te kom en die aarde met die bandvloek tref nie.
Notice the accuracy of the Holy Spirit, that it would not confuse them two comings of Elijah.
Let op die akkuraatheid van die Heilige Gees, dat dit nie daar die twee komste van Elia sou verwar nie.
Malachi 3 said, behold, I send my messenger before my face.
Malachi 3 het gesê, kyk, ek stuur my boodskapper voor my aangesig.
Jesus asked about John.
Jesus was gevra oor Johannes.
He said, if you can receive it, this is who the prophet said, I'll send my messenger before my face. This is the Elias that was to come. Malachi 3.
Hy het gesê, as julle dit kan ontvang, dit is wie die profeet gesê het, ek sal my boodskapper voor my aangesig stuur. Dit is die Elia wat moes kom, Malachi 3.
Notice the scripture so accurately gives it.
Let op, die skrif gee dit so akkuraat.
Watch what this, to show the, them who wants to believe, them who wants to see.
Kyk, wat hier die, om te wys die, hulle wat wil glo, hulle wat wil sien.
Remember Jesus stopped in the middle of the scripture? Because part of it was fulfilled then the rest for his second coming.
Onthou Jesus wat stop in die middel van die skrif, want het deel daarvan was toeverval, die rest voor sy tweede komst.
To preach the acceptable year of the Lord, bind up the brokenhearted and stop!
Om die aangename jaar van die Here aan te kondig, die wat verbrysel van hart is te genees, en gestop!
Not bring judgment to the Gentile, until his second coming.
Nie oordeel aan die heiden te bring nie, tot sy tweede komst.
Notice this scripture here parallels that.
Let op dat die skrif hier daarmee ooreenstem.
And he, Elijah, shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children.
En hy, Elia, sal die harte van die vaders terugbring tot die kinders.
Now speaking of Malachi 4, not get it mixed, or Malachi 3.
Praat nou van Malachi 4, dit nie vermeng nie, of Malachi 3.
John, Elijah, who came in the days before the first coming of Christ.
Johannes, Elia, wat gekom het in die dag voor die eerste komst van Christus.
Turn the hearts of the old patriarch fathers to the message of the children. The new message.
Het die harte van die aartsvaders teruggebring na die boodskap van die kinders. Die nieuwe boodskap.
Now watch. And the hearts of the children to the fathers.
Nou kyk. En die harte van die kinders na die vaders.
In his second coming, in the last days, he turns back to the apostolic faith again.
Amen. En sy tweede komst. In die laaste dag, bring hy die apostoliese geloof weer terug.
See how perfect the scriptures line up.
Sien hoe perfect die skrifte oplyn.
That was the end of the Old Testament. The Old Testament.
Dit was die einde van die Old Testament. Die Old Testament.
Now, we see there's light in the evening time.
Nou, sien ons, daar's lig in die aandtyd.
What is it? It's the top, Mount Treetop. As I said this morning.
Wat is dit? Dit is die top. Boom, topberg. Soos ek vanmorgen gesê het.
We've come up through denominations, through not an orange tree like I spoke of this morning.
Ons het opgekom, deur die denominaties. Deur nie een lemoenboom nie, soos ek vanmorgen gepraat het.
But we've had grapefruit, lemons, all kinds of other things. That wasn't like the beginning at all.
Maar ons het pomelo's gehad, seerlimoene, alle soorte van ander dinge wat glad nie, soos die begin was nie.
But after, don't miss it, here it comes.
Maar na, moet het nie mis nie, hier kom dit.
After all the denominations is played out, they didn't have any light to begin with.
Na, al die denominaties uitgespeel is, had het nie enige lig gehad om mee te begin nie.
There will be a day that can't be called day or night.
Sal daar 'n dag wees wat nie dag of nag genoem kan word nie.
What are they doing? What are they doing?
Wat doen hulle? Wat doen hulle?
What does a lemon do on an orange tree?
Wat maak 'n suurlemoen aan 'n lemoenboom?
It takes the original life of the orange that's coming up and perverts it. To a lemon!
Dit neem die oorspronklike lewe van die lemoen wat opkom en verdraai dit deur 'n suurlemoen.
That's what the denominations has done to the word of God.
Dis wat die denominasies gedoen het aan die woord van God.
Made the word of God of no effect by their traditions.
Die woord van God kragteloos gemaak deur hulle tradisies.
That's thus saith the Spirit of the Lord.
Dis so spreek die Gees van die Here.
They have brought forth lemons, grapefruits, not oranges.
Hulle het suurlemoene, pomelos voortgebring, nie lemoene nie.
But what did the prophet say?
Maar wat het die profeet gesê?
The same one that said for our text tonight.
Dieselfde een wat vir ons teks vanaand gesê het.
Rejoice, O daughters of Jerusalem. Shout loud, daughters of Zion.
Verheug, O dogters van Jerusalem. Juig hard, dogters van Sion.
For your king's coming to you. Meek and lowly, sitting upon the foal of an ass.
Want julle koning kom na julle sagmoedig en nederig en sit op die foal van 'n esel.
Notice, that same prophet said there will come a time of the ripening of the sun set upon the earth to ripen the fruit.
Let op, daar dieselfde profeet het gesê, daar kom 'n tyd van die rypwording. Die son word op die aarde gestuur om die vrugte ryp te maak.
Why couldn't it ripen?
Waarom kon dit nie ryp maak nie?
There's no fruit there to ripen. But the life is still traveling on.
Daar is geen vrugte daar om ryp te maak nie, maar die lewe gaan steeds voort.
It come up to a grapefruit to be an orange. Found out it organized. It was a grapefruit.
Dit het opgekom deur 'n pomelo om 'n lemoen te wees. Uitgevind, dit het georganiseer, dit was 'n pomelo.
It went again. It come out that time a lemon.
Dit het weer gegaan. Dit het daardie keer uitgekom as 'n suurlemoen.
Went on again, it turned out to something else.
Weer aangegaan. Dit het gebleik om iets anders te wees.
And in the last top of the tree, it's turned out to a tangelo. Which is half orange and half lemon.
En in die laaste top van die boom het uitgekom as 'n tangelo. Wat 'n half lemoen, half suurlemoen is.
A mixed breed, a perverted thing.
'N gemengde geslag, 'n verdraaide ding.
Come on to a perversion, living off that same tree.
Aangekom na 'n verdraaiing wat lewe van dieselfde boom.
The shock almost deceived the elect. It looks like an orange, but it ain't.
Die dop, amper die uitverkorenes mislei, lyk na 'n lemoen, maar dis nie.
But it shall be like when she grows beyond organization.
Maar dit sal lig word wanneer sy bo organisasie uitgroei.
When she gets out of past organization and blooms out again, she'll put forth oranges like she was when she went into the ground.
Wanneer sy verby organisasie uitgaan, dit weer uitblom, sal dit weer lemoene voortbring soos dit was voor sy in die grond ingegaan het.
And then it shall be light.
En dan sal dit lig wees.
What's this attraction? What's this happening?
Wat is hier die aantrekkingskrag? Wat is hier die gebeurtenis?
Fulfilling God's word.
Vervulling van God se woord.
There's two witnesses of the Old Testament that this would happen.
Daar is twee getuies van die Ou Testament dat hierdie sou gebeur.
Let's take John 14:12 of the New Testament.
Laat ons Johannes 14:12 neem van die Nuwe Testament.
Jesus said, "He that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also."
Het Jesus gesê, "Wie in my glo, die werke wat ek doen, sal hy ook doen."
Also in Luke 17:22 to 30, he said,
ook in Lukas 17:22 tot 30 het hy gesê,
as it was in the days of Lot before Sodom was burned,
soos dit was in die dae van Lot voor Sodom verbrand is,
so shall it be at the return of the Son of Man. that day when the Son of Man is being revealed.
So sal het wees by die terugkeer van die Seun van die Mens. Daar die dag wanneer die Seun van die Mens geopenbaar word.
Oh, just look at the scriptures.
Whoa, kyk net na die skrifte.
The Son of Man. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and forever.
Die Seun van die Mens. Jesus Christus, dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd.
Grow to past denominations. Grow into the top of the tree.
Het voorbij denominaties gegroei. Het gegroei naar die top van die boom.
What did he say in John 14 or 15?
Wat het hy gesê in Johannes 14 of 15?
Every branch that's in me that doesn't bring forth the fruit, it'll be cut off and pruned, thrown into the fire and burned.
Elke loot wat in my is, wat nie vrug dra nie, dit sal afgesny en gesny word, in die veer gegooi en verbrand word.
Whatever branch that'll bring forth fruit, it'll be purged.
Maar elke loot wat vruchte dra, dit sal gereinig word.
Oh, there'll be a true farmer in latter rain. In the last days, upon that little group that come with him on this little donkey.
Oh, daar sal een ware saai en oes reen in die laaste dag wees. Op daar die klein groepie wat saam met hom sal kom. Op hier die donkey.
Low and humble, no daughter denomination, crying, Hosanna to the King that comes in the name of the Lord.
Laag en nederig, geen de of denominatie wat skree, Hosanna aan die koning wat kom in die naam van die Heere.
What's the matter today? What's the attraction on the mount?
Wat is die probleem vandag? Wat is die aantrekkingskrag op die berg?
Not long ago standing at this pulpit, it was said by the Holy Spirit,
nie lang gelede nie gestaan by hier die preekstoel, was het gesê deur die Heilige Gees.
The day will come that when they'll drive down a stake in front of your house, they'll move your gate so that you'll bypass it, not be angry.
Die dag sal aanbreek wanneer hulle paal voor jou huis sal inslaan. Hulle sal jou hek skuif, so daar jy sal verby dit gaan, nie kwaad wees nie.
I seen my gate tore up and laying out upon the hillside. I seen the hill in front of me all dug up. Boards and things laying there where something mashed it up.
Ek het my hek opgebreek gesien en wat buite op die heuvel lê. Ek het die heuvel voor my gesien, heeltemal opgegrawe. Borde en goed wat daar lê, waar iets dit stuk in gebreek het.
He said, I looked and there was a little Ricky that had got up there and knocked that gate out, done this.
Hy het gesê, ek het gekyk, en daar was 'n klein Riekie wat opgekom het, daar, en daar die hek omgestamp, hy het gedoen het.
So I said, why didn't you tell me? You got smart with me. And I had to hit him.
Ek het gesê, hoekom het hy my nie gesê nie? Hy het slim geraak met my, en ek moet hom slaan.
When it did, I said, I haven't done this since I was in the ring, but I just want you to know. And I swatted him on.
En toe dit het, het ek gesê, ek het dit nie gedoen van dat ek in die kruit was nie. Maar ek wil net hê, jy moet weet. En ek het hom een gegee.
And when I knocked him down, I picked him up again, knocked him down again.
En toe ek hom plat geslaan het, het ek hom weer opgetel en hom weer plat geslaan.
I picked him up 3 or 4 times and kicked him over the hill.
Ek het hom opgetel 3 of 4 keer, hom toe oor die heuvel geskop.
So then I went over there and I said, that ain't right.
So toe het ek so intoe gegaan en ek het gesê, dit is nie reg nie.
I picked him up and shook his hands. I said, I'm not angry with you. But I just want you to know. You can't talk to me like that.
En ek het hom opgetel en sy hande geskud. Ek het gesê, ek is nie kwaad vir jou nie. Maar ek wil net hê jy moet weet. Jy kan nie so met my praat nie.
And then when I turned and come back, the Holy Spirit was standing there at the gate. Said, now bypass this. When that stakes drove down, turned westward.
En toe ek omgedraai en teruggekom het, het die Heilige Gees daar by die hek gestaan, gesê, nou gaan hierby voorbij. Wanneer daar die paal ingekap word, draai westwaarts.
This book is everything that I need. This book is a good recipe. The way the shoals to go around my trouble.
Hier die boek, alles wat ek nodig het. Hier die boek is 'n goeie resep. Die weg om te wys om my probleem te gaan.
Amen. That book is the word, and that word is God.
Amen. En daar die boek is die woord, en daar die woord is God.
Bypass your troubles. It'll tell you what to do.
Gaan voorbij jou probleme. Dit sal jou sê wat om te doen.
3 years ago, I heard a friend of mine, the city surveyor, lives down the lane from me driving a stake down.
3 jaar gelede het ek 'n vriend van my gehoor, die stadsopmeter, wat onder in die straat van my af woon, wat 'n paal inkap.
I went out there and said, what's the matter, Mud? Mr. King's son, where's your friend?
Ek het so intoe gegaan en gesê, wat's die probleem, Mud? Meneer King's seun, persoonlike vriend.
He said, Billy, we're going to widen this road.
Gesê, Billy, hulle gaan hier die pad breer maak.
You all remember?
Yes,
amen. Julle almal onthou?
I said, it may be the bridge. I told Brother Woods, I said, hold your property.
Ek het gesê, dit mag die brug wees. Ek het vir Broer Woods gesê, hou jou eiendom.
Maybe that bridge is going to come through up here. Something.
Misschien gaan daar die brug hierbo deurkom. Iets.
The lane was tore up. Bricks, rocks, brought all over everything.
Die laan is opgebreek. Bakstene, klippe, alles, oor alles gegooi.
So he said, I said, hold your property.
So, ek het gesê, hou jou eiendom.
And then when Mr. King told me that was going to happen, I went in and said, my wife's sitting there.
Meneer King het vir my gesê dat het gaan gebeur. Ek het ingegaan vir my vrou wat daar gesit het.
Honey, there's something written about that. Thus saith the Lord somewhere.
Gesê, skat, daar is iets daaroor geskryf. Dis so spreek die Here iewers.
I went and got my book, looked into it, it said it shall come to pass. 8 years later.
Ek het ingegaan en my boek gekry, daarin gekyk. En dit het gesê, dit sal gebeur. 8 jaar later.
Then, when I looked at it, I said, it's time now, honey. We must turn west.
Toe ek daarna gekyk het, het ek gesê, dis nou tyd, skat. Ons moet westwaarts draai.
2 days after that, standing in the room about 10 o'clock one morning.
2 dae daarna, in die kamer gestaan, omtrent 10:00 een morgen.
I went into the spirit of God, and I saw that little cluster of doves flying. Look, them little birds, you remember it.
Het ek in die geest van God ingegaan. Ek het daar die klein groepie duwes in vlieg gekyk. Na daar die klein voeltjies, julle onthou dit?
Amen.
I seen 7 angels in the form of a pyramid come rushing into me.
Ek het 7 engele in die vorm van 'n piramide gesien wat in my invlieg.
Said, turn westward.
Amen.
Go to Tucson, be 40 miles northeast.
Gesê, draai westwaarts. Ga na Tucson, sal 40 mil noordwest wees.
And you'll be picking a cockleburr, or a bullheader, they call it there, off your clothes.
En jy sal een klitsgras optel, of een bulkop, soos hulle dit daar noem, van jou kleren af.
Brother Fred Softman sitting there looking at me right now, was there that morning.
Broer Fred Softman, wat nou recht daar na my sit en kyk, was daar die ochend.
I forgot about it.
Ek het daarvan vergeet.
I said a blast went off like an earthquake that shook for near everything there was in the country.
Ek het gesê, ontploffing het afgegaan soos 'n aardbewing, wat omtrent alles geskud het wat in die land was.
I don't see how a man could survive it.
Ek sien nie hoe 'n mens dit kan oorleef nie.
I was scared.
Ek was bang.
I stood at Phoenix, you all listening in the night, bear me record.
Ek het by Phoenix gestaan, julle wat allemaal vanavond inluister, is my getuie.
I preached on the sermon, sirs, what time is it?
Ek het gepreek. Hoor die preek, meneere, wat is die tyd?
Where are we at?
Waar by is ons?
I went west.
Ek het na die weste gegaan.
Many of you here got that tape. Many of you here heard it said, year or more before it happened.
Baie van julle hier het daar die band. Baie van julle hier het met het gehoor sê, jaar of meer voor het gebeur het.
I went west wondering what was going to happen.
Ek het na die weste gegaan, gewonder wat sou gebeur.
One day I got a call. From the Lord.
Eendag het ek 'n oproep van die Here gekry.
I told my wife, I said, honey, I'm probably, my work is over.
Ek het vir my vrou gesê, skat, my werk is waarskynlik voorby.
I didn't know.
Ek het nie geweet nie.
I said, God's probably finished with me now and I'll be going home.
Ek het gesê, God is waarskynlik nou klaar met my en ek sal huis toe gaan.
You go get with Billy. Take your children. God will make a way for you somehow.
Ga nie na Billy toe. Neem die kinders. God sal 'n weg vir jou maak op 'n manier.
One live true to God. See that the children get through school. Raise them in the admonition of God.
Gaan aan en lewe getrou aan God. Sien dat die kinders deur die skool kom. Maak hulle groot in die vrees van God.
She said, Bill, you don't know that's true.
Sy het gesê, Bill, jy weet nie. Jy weet nie, dis waar nie.
I said, no, but a man couldn't survive that.
Ek het gesê, nee, maar 'n mens kon dit nie oorleef nie.
One morning, the Lord woke me up, said, get up, young Sabine, tell him.
Een oggend het die Here my wakker gemaak, gesê, gaan daar bo na Sobino Canyon.
I took a piece of paper and my Bible.
Ek het 'n stuk papier en my Bybel geneem.
The wife said, where are you going?
Die vrou het gesê, waar na toe gaan jy?
I said, I don't know. I'll tell you when I come back.
Ek het gesê, ek weet nie. Ek sal jou sê as ek terugkom.
I went up in the canyon, climbed up where the eagles was flying around.
Ek het opgegaan in die canyon, reg opgeklim tot waar die arende rond gevlieg het.
I was watching some deer standing there.
Ek het 'n paar takbokke dopgehou wat daar gestaan het.
I knelt down to pray and raised up my hands and a sword struck my hand.
Ek het gekniel om te bid en my hande opgesteek en 'n swaard het my hand getref.
I looked around and thought, what's that? I'm not beside myself. Here's that sword in my hand, bright, shiny, glistening in the sun.
Ek het omgekyk, ek het gedink, wat is dit? Ek is nie buite myself nie. Hier is daar die swaard in my hand, helder, blink, skitterend in die son.
I said, now there's not people in miles anyway up here in this canyon. Where could that come from?
Ek het gesê, nou, daar's nie mense binne myle van my af nie. Ver hierbo in hierdie canyon. Waar kon dit vandaan kom?
I heard a voice said, that's the king's sword.
Ek het 'n stem gehoor gesê, dis die koning se swaard.
I said, a king knights a man with a sword.
Ek het gesê, 'n koning slaan 'n man tot ridder met 'n swaard.
The voice come back said, not a king's sword, but the king's sword.
Amen.
The word of the Lord.
Hey, die stem het teruggekom, gesê, nie 'n koning se swaard nie, maar die koning se swaard. Die woord van die Here.
Said, fear not. It's only the third pull. It's the vindication of your ministry.
Gesê, moenie vrees nie. Dis slegs die derde trek. Die bevestiging van jou bediening.
I was going hunting with a friend. Not knowing what was going to happen.
Ek het gaan jag saam met 'n vriend. Nie geweet wat sou gebeur nie.
And someone called me. The one that criticized me about that picture of the angel of the Lord. The one that took it.
En iemand het my gebel, die een wat my gekritiseer het oor die foto van die engel van die Here, die een wat dit geneem het.
I had to go to Houston about his son, or he's going in the death row, he's going to be killed in a few days.
Ek moes na Houston toe gaan oor sy seun, want hy was doodstraf afwagtend en sou doodgemaak word binne 'n paar dae.
He met me there and threw his arms around me, said, "Think the very man that I criticized comes to save my only son."
En hy het my daar binne ontmoet, sy arms om my gegooi, gesê, dank, die eenste man wat ek gekritiseer het, kom om my enigste seun te red.
You mean society give me a, what they call an Oscar, whatever you want to call it, for saving a life.
Die menslikheidsvereniging het vir my gegee wat hulle 'n Oscar noem, of wat jy dit ook al wil noem, vir die red van 'n lewe.
Then we went back. I went up in the mountain to hunt.
Toe ons teruggegaan het, het ek opgegaan in die berg om te jag.
There, brother Fred and I one morning when I walked out.
Daar ek en broer Fred een môre toe ek uitgestap het.
Yes, I'd already got my javelina and I looked and seen the place where we were and I said, brother Fred, go over on that mountain early in the morning now, about to break a day and I'll get on the other.
En ek het alreeds my javelina gehad en ek het gekyk en die plek gesien waarheen hulle gegaan het. Ek het gesê, broer Fred, gaan nou vroeg in die môre op daardie berg rondom dagbreek en ek sal op die ander een gaan.
I won't shoot at the hog, won't kill him, but if they start over this way they hurt, I'll shoot in front of them and run them back.
Ek sal nie na die vark skiet om doodmaak nie. Maar as hulle begin oorkom na hierdie kant, daar die trop, sal ek voor hulle skiet en hulle dan terugjag.
Brother Fred went out there and there's no hogs.
Broer Fred het daar uitgegaan en daar was geen wildsvarke nie.
He waved at me and I seen him went down in the canyon, some big chasms. Sun is just coming up.
Hy het vir my gewaai. En ek het gesien, ek het afgegaan in 'n canyon, 'n paar groot klowe. Die son het pas opgekom.
I come around the other side of the hill, not thinking nothing about the prophecies. Sit down, waiting, resting. I thought, what happened to those hogs?
Ek het om die ander kant van die heuwel gekom, niks gedink aan die profesie nie. Gaan sit, gewag, gerus. Ek het gedink, wat het gebeur met daardie wildsvarke?
I picked up my, sit down like Indians do, you know, cross-legged.
Ek het opgetel my, gaan sit soos die Indiane, julle weet, kruisbeen.
I looked on my overhaul leg and there was a bullheader.
Ek het gekyk op my oorpakpyp en daar was 'n bulkop.
I picked it up. I said, that's strange.
Ek het opgetel en ek het gesê, dis vreemd.
Here I am about 40 miles northeast of Tucson.
Hier is ek, omtrent 40 myl noordoos van Tucson.
There's my little boy Joseph sitting there waiting for me.
Daar's my klein seentjie Joseph wat daar vir my sit en wag.
And as I started to look, I seen a herd of hogs come out about 1,000 yards from me up on a mountain.
En ek het begin kyk, ek het 'n trop wilsvarke sien op uitkom omtrent 1,000 yards van my af, boop 'n berg.
I told the bullheader down, I said, I'll get him.
Ek het daar die bulkop neergegooi, ek het gesê, ek sal hulle kry.
I'll go get Brother Fred and I'll hang up a piece of paper to let know which way to go on this old cotilla here, and we'll get Brother Fred.
Ek sal vir Brother Fred gaan kry en ek sal 'n stuk papier ophang om te laat weet watter kant toe om te gaan op hierdie cotilla hier, en ons sal Brother Fred kry.
I started up the mountain running as hard as I could on the other side.
En ek het opgegaan met die berg so vinnig gehardloop as wat ek kon aan die ander kant.
All of a sudden, I thought somebody shot me.
Met Jens het ek gedink iemand het my geskiet.
I never heard such a blast that shook the whole country.
Ek het nooit so 'n ontploffing gehoor nie. Dit het die hele land geskud.
And what it did, standing before me was 7 angels in a cluster.
En toe dit het daar 7 engele in 'n groep voor my gestaan.
I met Brother Fred and him a little later, said, what was
it? Ek het Broer Fred en hulle ontmoet a bietjie later gesê, wat was dit?
That was it.
Ek het gesê, dit was dit.
What are you going to do?
Wat gaan jy doen?
Return home.
Huis toe gaan.
For thus saith the Lord, the 7 mysteries that's been hid in the Bible all these years.
Want so spreek die Here, die 7 verborgenhede wat versteek was in die Bybel al hierdie jare.
These denominations and everything, God is going to open those 7 mysteries to us in the 7 seals.
Hier die denominasies en alles, God gaan daar die 7 verborgenhede aan ons oopmaak in die 7 seals.
There was that circle coming up from the earth, like a mist forming.
Daar het daar die sirkel opgekom uit die aarde, soos 'n mis wat vorm.
When it did, it went from up into the mountain, began to circle on westward from the way it come.
Toen het het weg opgegaan in die bergen, westwaarts begin sirkel, waar dit vandaan gekom het.
Science found it after a while, 30 miles high and 25 miles across, just exactly in the circle of the pyramid.
Wetenskap het het naderhand gevind, 30 mijl hoog en 25 mijl breed, net precies in die sirkel van die piramide.
And the other day, standing there, turned the picture to the right, and there's Jesus. As he was in the 7 church ages.
En nou die dag daar gestaan, die foto na rechts gedraai, en daar is Jesus, soos hy was in die 7 kerkeeuwe.
The white wig on, showing supreme deity.
Die wit pruik aan, wat opperste goddelikheid aandui.
He's Alpha and Omega. He's the first and the last.
He is Alpha and Omega. Hy is die eerste en die laaste.
He is the supreme judge of all eternity. Standing there to confirm the message of this hour.
Hy is die opperste rechter van alle ewigheid. Wat daar staan, die boodskap van hierdie uur bevestig.
And there shall be light about the evening time.
En daar sal lig wees teen die aandtyd.
What's it all about? What was it? I went westward.
Waaroor gaan dit alles? Wat was dit? Ek het westwaarts gegaan.
Up on that same mountain. Passing up with Banks Woods there.
Op daar die selfde berg. Opgegaan saam met Banks Woods daar.
Said, throw up a rock. Say to Mr. Woods, thus saith the Lord. You'll see the glory of God.
Gesê, gooi 'n klip op. Sê aan meneer Woods, so spreek die Here. Jy sal die heerlikheid van God sien.
The very next day, standing there, a whirlwind came down and blasted the mountains out.
Met die volgende dag, daar gestaan, het 'n warrelwind afgekom en die berge weggeblaas.
Rocks cut the top of the trees off, about 3 or 4 feet above my head.
Rots het die top van die bome afgesny, omtrent 3 of 4 voet bokant my kop.
Made 3 big blasts. The brothers come run over.
Het 3 groot ontploffings gemaak. En die broers het oorgehardloop gekom.
There was about 15 men standing there, preachers and everything else.
Daar het omtrent 15 mannen daar gestaan, predikers en alles.
What was it? He said, what was it?
Wat was dit? Hy het gesê, wat was dit?
I said, judgment is striking the west coast.
Ek het gesê, oordeel, tref die Weskus.
About 2 days after that, the earthquake almost sunk Alaska.
Omtrent 2 dae daarna, het die aardbeving Alaska omtrent gesunk.
What is this light? Up on Sunset Mountain, in the Coronado Forest of Arizona.
Wat is hier die lig? Bo op Sunset Berg, in die Coronado Woud van Arizona.
What is this strange thing that happened up there? That the people's been driving east from west, picking up the rocks that laid around their horse truck.
Wat is hier die vreemde ding wat daarbo gebeur het? Dat die mense oos na wes gery het, rots opgetel het wat daar rondom gelê het, waar dit getref het.
And every one rock has 3 corners on it that it tore off. The 3R1.
Amen. En elkeen van hulle, elke rots, het 3 hoeke daaraan, wat het afgeskeer het. Die 3 is 1.
They're laying on desks on paperweights across the nation.
Hulle lê op lessenaars, op papiergewigte, oor die nasie.
What is this strange thing up on Sunset Mountain in the Coronado Forest?
Wat is hier die vreemde ding op Sunset Berg in die Coronado Woud?
Junior Jackson listening in. You remember the dream he had it interpreted, going towards the setting of the sun.
Junior Jackson, wat in luister. Onthou jy die droom wat hy gehad het, wat ek uitgeleë het? In die rigting van die ondergaande son gaan.
And this happened on Sunset Mountain.
En hierdie het gebeur op Sunset Berg.
It's the evening time. Sunset time.
Dis die aandtyd. Sonsondergangtyd.
The sunset message. Just setting of history.
Die sonsondergang boodskap. Deur 'n ondergang van geskiedenis.
A setting of prophecy, brother, being fulfilled.
'N ondergang van profesie, liewer, wat vervul word.
And it shall be light at the evening time up on Sunset Mountain in the Coronado Forest, 40 miles north of Tucson.
En dit sal lig wees teen die aandtyd op Sunset Berg. In die Coronado Woud, 40 mijl noord van Tucson.
Get on the map and see Sunset Peak there. That's exactly where it happened. I never knew it till the other day.
Kijk op die kaart en kijk of Sunset Peak daar is. Dit is precies waar dit gebeur het. Ek het nooit geweet, tot nou die dag nie.
Everything that shall never die, it's constantly unrolling itself.
Alles wat, daar is sal nooit sterf nie. Dit ontvouw het self gedierig.
From the very thing happening to the picture being Jesus standing looking at us and now exactly on Sunset Mountain.
Van die eerste ding wat gebeur het, tot die foto wat Jesus was, wat nou ons staan en kyk, en nou precies op Sunset Berg.
And the sunset light, the evening light, has come.
En die sonsondergangslig, die aandlig, het gekom.
God vindicating himself.
God wat homself bevestig.
What is it? It is the facts. That God in Christ are one.
Wat is dit? Dit is die feite dat God in Christus een is.
The white, how many seen it? The white wig upon him as we talked in Revelation 1.
Die wit, hoeveel het dit gesien? Die wit pruik op hom, soos ons gepraat het in Openbaring 1.
See, the supreme deity.
Sien, die opperste goddelikheid.
Supreme authority.
Opperste gesag.
No other voice, no other God, no other nothing.
Geen ander stem nie, geen ander God nie, geen ander niks nie.
In him dwells the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
In hom woon die volheid van die Godheid liggaamlik.
The angels themselves was his wig. Amen.
Die engele self was sy pruik. Amen.
What's happened up on Mount Sunset? God confirming his word. That's what all this noise is about.
Wat het gebeur op Sunsetberg? God wat sy woord bevestig, dis waaroor al hierdie geraas gaan.
Notice, it's God fulfilling His promised word again of Revelations 10, 1-7.
Let op, dis God wat weer sy beloofde woord vervul van Openbaringe 10, 1-7.
And in the days of the sounding of the seventh angel's message, the mystery of God should be finished.
En in die dag van die stem van die sewende engelse boodskap, sou die verborgenheid van God voltooi wees.
The hidden mystery of Revelations 10:1-7, the last message to the last church age.
Die versteekte verborgenheid van Openbaringe 10:1-7, die laaste boodskap aan die laaste kerk.
Fulfills exactly in this age St. Luke 17:30. The day when the Son of Man shall be revealed.
Vervul precies in hierdie eeuw, Lukas 17:30, die dag wanneer die Seun van die mens geopenbaar sal word.
And there shall rise false prophets and false Christ, show great signs and wonders, insomuch as to deceive the elected, if possible.
En daar sal valse profete en valse Christusse opstaan, groot tekens en wonders toon, in soverre dat het die eindste uitverkorende soms lei, indien mondelik.
The people still in doubt. And as usual, the church is just as puzzled.
Die mense steeds in twyfel, en soos gewoonlik is die kerk net so verward.
And the science, all through Tucson, yet they're writing pieces and putting the paper.
En die wetenskap, nog reg deur Tucson, skryf hulle stukke en sit het in die korant.
Way back around Mount Lemmon, them big cameras. Didn't see it rising up from where we were standing.
Ver daar oorkant, op Lemmonberg, het daar die groot kameras, dit nie sien opstijg van waar ons gestaan het nie.
Drifting on towards the west, showing the time is over. It can't go but a little piece there, it's at the west coast.
Wat aangedreif het, na die weste gewys het, die tyd is voorbij. Dit kan nie meer as te klein deeltje daar gaan nie, dis by die westkus.
Judgment struck just in the very way it went.
Word het getref, net op diezelfde pad wat het gegaan het.
Going right up over Phoenix, right on across. On to Prescott and across the mountains to the west coast.
Rig het op oor Phoenix en rig het aan, oorgegaan, aan na Prescott en oor die berge na die westkus.
Right on up into, where was they going? Right on up into Alaska. And she's thundering, heading right that way.
Rig het op na, waar naartoe het hulle gegaan? Rig het op in Alaska in, en sy is donderende, rig het swint op pad.
And the observatories and all of them in Tucson are still asking research of science, trying to find out what it is.
En die sterre wacht in allemaal van hulle in Tucson vraag steeds, wetenskapelike navorsing wat probeer uitvind wat het is.
So high, there can't be fog, mist or nothing up there.
So hoog, hulle kan nie mis wees nie, nevel of niks daarbo nie.
What did it? Where's it at?
Wat het het gedoen? Waar is dit?
They're just as puzzled at that supernatural halo hanging there in the sky as it was when the Magi's come in following a star saying, where is he? That's born king of the Jews.
Hulle is net so verward oor daar die bonatierlijke stralekrans wat oorkant in die lig hang as wat hulle was toe die Magiërs ingekom het dier die ster te volg gesê, waar is hy wat gebore is, koning van die Jode?
What was it? God fulfilling his word.
Wat was dit? God wat sy woord vervul.
There shall rise a star out of Jacob.
En daar sal 'n ster opstaan uit Jakob.
And the God of heaven promised the evening time would have evening light.
En die God van die hemel het beloof die aandtyd sou aandlig te hê.
3 years ago this mystery was a prophecy. What time is it, sir? But now it's history.
3 jaar gelede was hier die verborgenheid 'n profesie. Watter tyd is dit, meneer? Maar nou is dit geskiedenis.
It's past. The promise is fulfilled.
Dit is verby. Die belofte is vervul.
What time is it, sir? And what's this attraction? God fulfilling his word.
Watter tyd is dit, meneer? En wat is hier die aantrekkingskrag? God wat sy woord vervul.
He's the same yesterday, today and forever. Let us pray.
Hy is dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd. Laat ons bid.
Dear God, I have helped the people at length, much longer than I intended.
Dierbare God, ek het die mense lang gehou,
Baie langer as wat ek bedoel het.
I pray, God, that something was said or done that will cause people out everywhere to understand.
Ek bid God dat iets gesê of gedoen was wat mense oral buite sal laat verstaan.
And by seeing and understanding, they might believe that thou art the true Christ.
En deur te sien en te verstaan, hulle mag glo dat U die ware Christus is.
And the words that's being confirmed is a confirmation of His word being perfect and being fulfilled in its season.
En die woorde wat bevestig is, die bevestiging is van Sy woord wat perfek is en vervul is in Sy seisoen.
Now, Lord Jesus, from Your own words, You said that the world would be in a Sodom condition.
Nou, Heere Jesus, van U eie woorde, U het gesê dat die wêreld in 'n Sodom toestand sal wees.
We know that, we can look at it.
Ons weet dit, ons kan daarna kyk.
And You said in that day, as it was in Sodom, there were 3 messengers sent to the Gentile and Hebrew world.
En U het gesê in daardie dag, soos dit was in Sodom, daar was 3 boodskappers gestuur na die heiden en Hebreëse wêreld.
And one of them, which was God Himself, the Son of Man,
en een van hulle, wat God self was, die Seun van die mens,
revealed Himself in a human form and performed a miracle insomuch that told Abraham what Sarah was doing behind him in the tent.
Het Homself openbaar in 'n menslike vorm en 'n wonderwerk gedoen in soverre om Abraham te vertel wat Sarah gedoen het agter hom in die tent.
You said it would repeat again when the whole Gentile world would be in a Sodom condition. And we're here, Lord.
Jy het gesê dit sal weer herhaal wanneer die hele heidenwêreld in 'n Sodom toestand sou wees. En ons is hier, Here.
Other prophecies confirming the same thing of sending Elijah in the last days, the spirit of Elijah upon the earth.
Ander profeseë wat dieselfde ding bevestig van die stuur van Elia in die laaste dae, die gees van Elia op die aarde.
To bring the hearts of the fathers or the children back to the fathers.
Om die harte van die vaders of die kinders terug te bring na die vaders.
Now pray, God, at this hour, that You will confirm Your word, that You are the same yesterday, today, and forever.
En ek bid, God, dat hierdie uur, dat U U woord sal bevestig, dat U dieselfde is gister, vandag, en vir altyd.
Grant it, Father. They are all Yours.
Skenk dit, Vader. Hulle is almal Use.
I pray that You'll grant these blessings and confirm what's been said for the glory of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Ek bid dat U hier die seëninge sal skenk en bevestig wat gesê is vir die heerlikheid van God. In die naam van Jesus Christus. Amen.
Just speak a word. Man. Confirm a word is God.
Om 'n woord te spreek is 'n man. 'n Woord te bevestig is God.
To say something is one thing. God to do it is another thing.
Om iets te sê is een ding. Vir God om dit te doen is 'n ander ding.
God don't need any interpreter. He does His own interpretation.
God het nie enige interpreteerder nodig nie. Hy doen sy eie interpretasie.
Now we're fixed to have a prayer line to pray for the sick. God willing.
Nou maak ons gereed om 'n gebedslyn te hê om te bid vir die siekes as God wil.
And we know that there's no one, no man, no woman, no human being, no angel that can heal you. For God has already did it.
En ons weet dat daar geen een, geen man, geen vrou, geen menslike wese, geen engel is wat julle kan genees nie, want God het dit alreeds gedoen.
He made the preparation. The only thing you have to do is receive it.
Hy het die voorbereidings getref. Die enigste ding wat julle moet doen is om dit te ontvang.
There's no man, no angel, no nothing. Not even God Himself can forgive you for your sins. It's already done. Jesus did that at the cross.
Daar is geen man, geen engel, geen niks nie. Nie eens God self wat jou kan vergewe van jou sondes nie. Dit is alreeds gedoen.
Jesus het het gedoen aan die kruis.
But he'll never prosper you anything or profit you anything until you accept it.
Maar dit sal jou nooit baat of enigiets of jou enigszins help, totdat jy dit aanvaar nie. Sien?
The only thing can be done is orders that's been given by God for believers to lay hands on the sick.
Die enigste ding wat gedoen kan word, is bevele wat deur God gegee is vir gelowiges om hande op die siekes te lê.
That's been through the ages they've done that, through revivals, and they've called it God.
Dit was deur die eeuwe het hulle dit gedoen, deur herlewings, en hulle het dit God genoem.
Abraham seen many signs, but there come a time when Abraham saw his last sign, just before Sodom was burned.
Abraham het baie tekens gesien, maar daar het die tyd aangebreek toe Abraham sy laaste teken gesien het, net voor Sodom verbrand het.
That was God manifesting himself in the form of a man.
En dit was God wat homself gemanifesteer het in die vorm van 'n man.
You believe that?
Glooi julle dit?
Did Jesus say it would repeat?
Het Jesus gesê dit sou herhaal?
Now how many in here and out in radio or out on the telephones across the nation, if you're still listening in, get ready now for prayer. Be praying.
Nou, hoeveel hier binne en buite in radio of buite op die telefone oor die nasie, as jy steeds inluister, maak nou gereed vir gebed. Bid.
You've got these handkerchiefs here?
En jylle wat hier die saktoeke hier het?
Now, I cannot tell God what to do. No, far be it from me even trying it.
Nou, ek kan nie vir God sê wat om te doen nie. Nee, ver is dit van my om dit selfs te probeer.
He's sovereign, he does what he wants to. I can only obey, and I only can say what he says.
Hy is soeverein, hy doen wat hy wil. Ek kan slechts gehoorsaam, en kan slechts sê wat hy sê.
And now, they're standing around the walls, they're packed in, it's congested.
En nou, staan hulle rondom die muur, hulle is ingeprop, is saamgedring.
I wonder, if we could ask God, on these words, what is this attraction?
Ek wonder, of ons God kon vra op hierdie woorde, wat is hierdie aantrekkingskrag?
If God would move among us again, there may be strangers here, and move among us and show his blessed face among us.
Of God weer onder ons sou beweeg, daar mag vreemdelinge hier wees, en onder ons beweeg en sy geseënde aangesig onder ons wys.
Show his spirit here.
Wys sy gees is hier.
Show that he's the same yesterday, today and forever.
Wys dat hy dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd is.
That every one of us, after these two strong messages, could believe it to be so. Could you do it? All right?
Dat elkeen van ons, na hier die twee sterk boodskappe, kon glo dat het so is. Kan julle dit doen? Goed.
Instead of calling a prayer line then, hot, congested, standing against water.
In plaas van 'n gebedslyn te roep dan, warm, saamgedring, wat jy in die muur staan,
well, look around this way to call my prayer line. You couldn't do it. Look standing there.
Ek kyk rond na hierdie kant om my gebedslyn te roep. Jy kon dit nie doen nie. Kyk wat daar staan.
Could I call it this way? Your sick cots, everything else laying. You couldn't do it.
Kon ek dit na hierdie kant toe roep? Julle siekes, siek beddens, alles wat lê. Jy kon dit nie doen nie.
So sit where you are. And believe God.
So sit waar jy is. En glo God.
If you do have a prayer card, hold it. It'll be good.
As jy wel 'n gebedskaart het, hou dit vas. Dit sal goed wees.
We'll get to you if you want to come to a line. But you don't have to come to a line.
Ons sal by julle uitkom, as julle deur 'n lyn wil kom. Maar julle hoef nie deur 'n lyn te kom nie.
That Mr. Shepherd last Sunday night never come to no line.
Daar die meneer Shepherd vlede Sondag aand het nooit deur 'n lyn gekom nie.
I don't guess he had a prayer card.
Ek dink nie hy het 'n gebedskaart gehad nie.
Is Mr. Shepherd here tonight?
Is meneer Shepherd vanavond hier?
Or is he? Is he here? He's in the back.
Waar is hy? Is hy hier? Hy is in die achterkant.
Do you have a prayer card, Mr. Shepherd? You didn't. You didn't.
Het jy 'n gebedskaart gehad, meneer Shepherd? Jy het nie. Hy het nie.
He's sitting right there again tonight. That's a good place to be, Brother Shepherd.
Hy sit weer net daar vanaand. Dis 'n goeie plek om te wees, Broer Shepherd.
Not only have to be there, but just have faith.
Nie alleen moet jy daar wees nie, maar hê net geloof.
For remember, a little woman touched his garment and he felt it.
Want onthou, 'n klein vroutjie het sy kleed aangeraak en hy het dit gevoel.
And he's the same yesterday and forever.
En hy is dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd.
And a Hebrew letter in the New Testament said that he's a high priest tonight that can be touched by the feeling of your infirmities.
En die Hebreëse brief in die Nuwe Testament het gesê dat hy die hoëpriester is vanaand wat aangeraak kan word deur die gevoel van julle swakhede.
You believe that? Have faith then.
Glo julle dit? Het dan geloof.
Don't doubt it. Believe it. And it'll come to pass.
Moet dit nie betwyfel nie. Glo dit en dit sal gebeur.
You can have what you've asked for if you can believe it, but you got to believe it.
Jy kan hê wat jy waarvoor jy gevra het, as jy dit kan glo, maar jy moet dit glo.
Will you do it? Will all of you believe it?
Sal jy dit doen? Sal julle almal dit glo?
How many will believe it now? God bless you.
Hoeveel sal dit nou glo? God seën julle.
I don't know who's who. I don't know none of you.
Ek weet nie wie is wie nie. Ek ken niemand van julle nie.
It's not my business to know any of you. It's God's business to know these things.
Dis nie my besigheid om enige van julle te ken nie. Dis God se besigheid om hierdie dinge te weet.
But he will do it if you believe it. Will you believe it now?
Maar hy sal dit doen as julle dit sal glo. Sal julle dit nou glo?
Now, dear God, surely we're not a bunch of hybrid Christians. We shouldn't be. Somebody has to be petted and babied.
Nou, dierbare God, sekerlik is ons nie 'n klomp verbasterde Christene nie. Ons behoort nie te wees nie. Iemand wat gesis en gepamper lang moet word nie.
You don't have that kind, Lord. You have rugged believers.
U het nie daardie soort nie, Here. U het geharde gelowiges.
The very presence of God sets a man's heart on fire.
Die eenste teenwoordigheid van God maak 'n man se hart brandende.
Like Abraham. He believed God.
Soos Abraham, hy het God geglo.
You made yourself known to him. Then you appeared to him and performed a sign. And he believed you.
U het uself aan hom bekend gemaak. Toe het u aan hom verskyn en 'n teken gedoen en hy het u geglo.
You turned his body back to a young man and also his wife, which his wife was part of his own body.
U het sy liggaam terug verander na 'n jong man en sy vrou ook. Wat sy vrou was deel van sy eie liggaam.
Then come forth the new child, the promised son.
Toe het die nuwe kind voorgekom, die beloofde seun.
God, you promised that it be the same thing in this day.
God, jy het beloof dat dit dieselfde ding in hierdie dag sou wees.
I pray that you'll confirm this word.
Ek bid dat u hierdie woord sal bevestig.
And we'll deal right on that one promise there, that it will be like it was in Sodom.
En ons sal handel reg op daardie een belofte daar, dat dit sal wees soos dit was in Sodom.
Just before Sodom was burnt and judgment struck Sodom, the Gentile world.
Net voor Sodom verbrand en oordeel Sodom getref het, die heiden wêreld.
So judgment is fixed to strike the Gentile world.
So is die oordeel gereed om die heiden wêreld te tref.
And the Jews got 3.5 more years through the period of tribulation, Jacob's trouble, the continuing of the 70 weeks of Daniel.
En die Jode het nog 3.5 jaar deur die verdrukkingsperiode, Jakob se verdrukking, die voortsetting van die 70 weke van Daniel.
But the Gentiles are numbered. It's time to go.
Maar die heidense is getel. Dis tyd om te gaan.
And you give that sign and you said it would be again.
En u het daardie teken gegee en u het gesê dit sou weer wees.
Grant it, God. We're in your hands. Do with us as you see fit. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Skenk dit, God. Hulle is, ons is in u hande. Doen met ons soos dit u behaag. In Jesus Christus se naam. Amen.
Now, don't be nervous. What would it be if I was nervous?
Nou, Moenie senuweeagtig wees nie. Wat sou dit wees as ek senuweeagtig was?
Now I'm making a thing here that it has to depend on the sovereignty of God.
Nou, ek maak 'n ding hier wat dit moet afhang van die soewereiniteit van God.
But why do I do this?
Maar hoekom doen ek dit?
He said it would be. That settles it.
Hy het gesê dit sou wees. Dit handel dit af.
And if he makes himself that confirmed like that before you, well, can't you believe him? Certainly.
En as hy homself dit maak voor julle bevestig soos daardie, wel, kan julle hom nie glo nie? Sekerlik.
You just have faith now and believe.
Julle nou net geloof en glo.
Let me just look around, see where the Holy Spirit will lead, what he'll do.
Laat my net omkyk, sien waar die Heilige Gees sal lei, wat hy sal doen.
I don't know what he'll do. That's up to him.
Ek weet nie wat hy sal doen nie. Dit hang van hom af.
But if you'll just only have faith, only believe, all things are possible to them that believe.
Maar as jy net geloof sal hê, net sal glo, alles is moontlik vir hulle wat glo.
All of you believe that, raise up your hands and say, I do believe it. With all my heart, I believe it.
Glo julle almal dit? Steek op julle hande en sê, ek glo dit wel. Met my hele hart glo ek dit.
Now three will be a confirmation. If he'll do it three straight times to prove you that it's right.
Nou, drie sal 'n bevestiging wees. As jy dit drie keer agter mekaar kan doen, om aan julle te bewys dat dit reg is.
I don't care where you are, who you are, you just have faith and believe.
Ek ken nie om waar julle is, wie julle is nie. Jy net geloof en glo.
I don't stir.
Nou, moenie rond beweeg nie. Hierdie kant toe.
Lady, praying. I don't know. You just sit where you're at. You don't have to come.
Dame, wat bid? Ek ken jou nie. Sit net waar jy is. Jy hoef nie te kom nie.
I don't know you, but you're holding a little girl in your hand, or in your lap.
Ek ken jou nie, maar jy hou 'n klein dogtertjie in jou hand of in jou skoot.
I'm a total stranger to you. And the little girl looks normal, she looks well.
Ek is 'n algehele vreemdeling vir jou. En die klein dogtertjie lyk normaal, sy lyk gesond.
She's a pretty little girl, a little red-headed girl.
Sy is 'n mooi klein dogtertjie, klein rooikop dogtertjie.
Looking here at her, she don't look like she's crippled or anything. I don't know what's wrong with her.
Ek kyk hier na haar, sy lyk nie of sy krepel is of enigiets nie. Ek weet nie wat verkeerd is met haar nie.
Might not be for the child, it might be for you.
Dit mag nie vir die kind wees nie, dit mag vir jou wees.
But I just happened to see you sitting there, that child praying.
Maar ek het jou net daar sien sit met daardie kind en in gebed.
I have to talk to you a minute to catch your spirit, like Jesus said to the woman, bring me a drink.
Ek moet 'n oomblik met jou praat om jou gees te kry, soos Jesus gesê het aan die vrou, bring vir my iets om te drink.
See? Just to figure out one person.
Sê net om een persoon uit te place.
Brother Bryant and I'm sitting here, I know these people sitting here, they may be needy too, but you as a stranger.
Broer Bryant en hulle wat daar sit, ek ken hier die mense wat hier sit. Hulle mag behoeftig wees, ook, maar jy was 'n vreemdeling.
Do you believe me to be God's prophet?
Glo jy dat ek God se profeet is?
Do you believe these things that you've heard tonight is the truth?
Glo jy dat hier die dinge wat jy vanaand gehoor het, die waarheid is?
Now, if God will reveal to me something that you've done, or something you ought not have done.
Nou, as God iets wat jy gedoen het aan my sal openbaar, of iets wat jy nie behoort te gedoen het nie.
Or something's wrong with you, or what your desire is, you'll know where it's true or not, won't you?
Of iets verkeerds met jou, of wat jou begeerte is, sal jy weet of dit waar is of nie, sal jy nie?
And if he'll do that, will it confirm his word, that he's the same yesterday, today, and forever, and that St. Luke 17:30 is being manifested?
En as hy dit sal doen, sal dit sy woord bevestig dat hy dieselfde is gister, vandag en vir altyd? En dat Lukas 17:30 gemanifesteer is?
You believe it?
Glo jy dit?
Now the lady raised her hand, it were strangers.
Nou, die dame het haar hand opgesteek dat ons vreemdelinge is.
I don't know you. But I'm trying to contact your spirit one person. There's so many of you pulling.
Ek ken jou nie, maar ek probeer haar gees kontak. Een persoon. Daar is soveel van julle wat trek.
Now you believe this. With all your heart.
Nou, glo jy hierdie met jou hele hart.
Now it is for the little girl. It's not you.
Nou, dit is vir die klein dogtertjie. Dis nie jy nie.
You're nervous. But it ain't the nervousness that's bothering you.
Jy is senuweeagtig. Maar dit is nie die senuweeagtigheid wat jou pla nie.
The great thing on your heart's that little girl.
Die groot ding op jou hart is daardie klein dogtertjie.
You believe God can tell me what it is? You believe it?
En glo jy God kan my sê wat dit is? Glo jy dit?
Would it help you? Would you believe then?
Sal dit jou help? Sal jy dan glo?
It's a brain injury. That right?
Dis 'n breinbesering. Dit reg?
Now put your hand on the little child's head. Your hand.
Nou sit jou hand op die klein kindjie se kop. Jou hand.
Dear God, you said these signs shall follow them that believe. They'll lay their hands on the sick and they shall recover.
Dierbare God, U het gesê, vir hulle wat geglo het, sal hierdie tekens volg. Hulle sal hulle hand op die siekes lê en hulle sal gesond word.
The woman is a believer.
Die vrou is 'n gelowige.
Her hands upon the child. May it recover. In the name of Jesus Christ, I offer this prayer. Amen.
Haar hand is op die kind. Mag dit gesond word. In die naam van Jesus Christus doen ek hierdie gebed. Amen.
Now do you believe all of you?
Glo julle dit nou, almal van julle?
If thou canst believe, all things are possible. Certainly.
As julle kan glo, is alles moontlik, sekerlik.
I know the lady sitting next to her, but she's so sincerely looking this way.
Ek ken hier die dame wat langs haar sit. Maar sy kyk so opreg hier die kant toe.
I can't call her name, but if I look at her a minute, I would know.
Ek kan nie haar naam noem nie, maar as ek 'n oomblik na haar kyk, sou ek weet.
But I know the woman by looks, but I don't know what your trouble.
Maar ek ken die vrou van aansien, maar ek weet nie wat jou probleem is nie.
You believe God will let me know what your trouble is?
Glo ek, God sal my laat weet wat jou probleem is?
Would it help you? Sugar diabetes.
Sal dit jou help? Suiker siekte.
Now that's right, hold your hand. Certainly.
Nou, as dit reg is, steek jou hand. Sekerlik.
Happen to be the lady laying sat next to you has got the same thing.
Was dat die dame wat gelê het langs jou sit dieselfde ding het?
She's a stranger.
Sy is 'n vreemdeling.
The other lady's praying for somebody. A crippled child. You'd believe with all your heart, God would grant it.
Die ander dame bid vir iemand, 'n krepel kind. Jy met jou hele hart glo, sal God dit skenk.
Somebody back in here.
Iemand daar agterin.
Man sitting over there trying to get rid of smoking cigarettes.
Man wat daar sit wat probeer ontsla raak van sigarette rook.
You believe God will take him away from you? All right.
Glo jy God sal hulle wegneem van jou? Goed.
You believe? You can have it.
Glo jy? Jy kan dit hê.
I've never seen the man in my life.
Ek het nooit die man in my lewe gesien nie.
Here's a man, see a dark shadow hanging over this man right here, laying on a cot like or a chair.
Hier is 'n man. Sien daar die donker skaduwee wat oor hierdie man net hier hang, wat op soort van 'n siekbed lê of 'n stoel.
He's dying. He's shattered, he's got cancer.
Hy is sterwend. Hy is geskade. Hy het kanker.
I don't know the man, never seen him.
Ek ken nie die man nie, hom nooit gesien nie.
God knows all about you.
God weet alles van jou.
That's the truth, sir.
Dis die waarheid, meneer.
You believe God could tell me something about you, would it help you to receive your healing?
Glo jy God kan iets omtrent jou sê, sodat jou help om jou genesing te ontvang?
You was brought here by a friend.
Jy is hier naartoe gebring deur 'n vriend.
But you're not from here. You're somewhere where there's a big body of water that people fishes at. In Albany, Kentucky. That's
right. Maar jy is nie van hier nie. Jy is iewers waar daar 'n groot stuk water is, waarby mense vis vang. Ja, Albany, Kentucky. Dis reg.
Believe it and go back home well.
Glo en jy kan huis toe gaan, gesond.
Believe it's gone. If you believe it. You must believe it. Believe it's been done for you.
Glo dat dit weg is. As jy dit sal glo, jy moet dit glo. En glo dis vir jou gedoen.
You believe? You. from Tennessee. Got a boy, he's got asthma. Not here, but you breathe, and he'll be healed.
Glooi jy? Jy, vanaf Tennessee, het 'n seun wat asma het. Nie hier nie, maar ek glo dat hy genees sal word.
And take your handkerchief on your hand there to him. He'll be healed. He'll believe it.
Neem dan jou sakdoek, jou in jou hand daar. Na hom, hy sal genees word as hy dit sal glo.
The lady crying, sitting across from Dr. Vail there.
Die dame wat huil, wat oorkant Dr. Vail daar sit.
She shattered also, a dark shadow. I never seen a woman in my life. But she's got cancer.
Sy is ook geskadu, 'n donker skadu weer. Ek het nooit in my lewe daardie vrou gesien nie, maar sy het kanker.
She'll die if something isn't done for her.
Sy sal sterf as iets nie vir haar gedoen word nie.
You believe he'll heal you, lady?
Glooi jy hy sal jou gesond maak, dame?
You can have your healing. You'll just believe.
Jy kan jou genesing ontvang as jy net sal glo.
There's a little lady sitting right behind her with her handkerchief up over her mouth.
Daar's 'n klein dametjie wat net agter haar sit met 'n sakdoek bo oor haar mond.
She's also got ulcerated stomach. Sick.
Sy het ook 'n maagsweer, maag. Sick.
You've been having passing out spells, blinding, falling out.
Jy het flouters gehad, verblinding, omval.
Somebody brought you here.
Iemand het jou hier naartoe gebring.
You got female trouble.
Jy het vroue probleme.
If you believe, you can go home be well.
As jy sal glo, kan jy huis toe gaan, gesond wees.
You young man, you're a stranger, sitting right here in front of me, looking at me.
Jy jong man, jy's 'n vreemdeling wat reg hier voor my sit, na my kyk.
What are you, Puerto Rican or something?
Wat is jy? Puerto Rican of iets? Ja.
I mean, pardon me. I'm a stranger to you. You know that you're not even from my country.
Wat ek bedoel het, ek's 'n vreemdeling vir jou. Jy weet dit. Jy is nie eens van my land nie.
But you believe that God can give you the desire of your heart?
Maar glo jy dat God jou die begeerte van jou hart kan gee?
If I tell you what your desire is, will you receive it?
As ek jou sê wat jou begeerte is, sal jy dit ontvang?
You're seeking the baptism of the Holy Ghost. That is true.
Jy soek die doop van die Heilige Gees. Dit is waar.
Receive the Holy Ghost, my brother.
Ontvang die Heilige Gees, my broer.
Here's a colored man sitting way back here. Got a burden on his heart. As far as wife.
Hier is 'n kleerling man wat ver hier agter sit, het 'n las op sy hart. Dis vir sy vrou.
She's not here even.
Sy is nie eens hier nie.
She's got trouble with her feet.
Sy het 'n probleem met haar voete.
You believe in a healer? You do?
Glooi jy dat hy haar sal gesond maak? Glooi jy?
You're a stranger here. You're from across the sea. You're from Jamaica.
Jy is 'n vreemdeling hier. Jy kom van oorsee. Jy is van Jamaica.
You believe God can tell me who you are?
Glooi jy dat God my kan sê wie jy is?
Mr. Brady.
Meneer Brady.
You believe?
Glooi jy?
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today. And forever.
Jesus Christus is dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd.
This lady sitting right back over Nissan, next to Mrs. Wright there. She's got a burden on her heart.
Hier die dame wat reg hier oorkant aan hierdie punt sit, langs mevrou Wright daar. Sy het 'n las op haar hart.
She's praying for a daughter. She's up for an operation.
Sy bid vir 'n dogter. Sy moet gaan vir 'n operasie.
You believe with all your heart for her? She won't need it if you'll get her to believe it.
Glooi jy met jou hele hart vir haar? Sy sal dit nie nodig hê as jy haar dit kan laat glo nie.
I can't heal.
Ek kan nie genees nie.
Way back down in the nursery, I see the Spirit of the Lord, an angel, light moving in the nursery.
Ver agter oorkant in die kinderkamer, sien ek die gees van die Here, 'n engel, 'n lig wat beweeg in die kinderkamer.
It's over a young woman. And she's got a spiritual trouble she's wondering about.
Dis oor 'n jong vrou. En sy het 'n geestelike probleem waaroor sy wonder.
Seems like I ought to know the woman somehow.
Lyk asof ek die vrou behoort te ken op 'n manier.
A young woman. She's also got a female disorder.
'N Jong vrou. Sy het ook 'n vroue ongesteldheid.
Yes. Her name is Mrs. West. From Alabama. Miss David West.
Ja, haar naam is mevrou West
van Alabama, mevrouw David West.
Believe. God will grant it to you.
Glo, God zal dit aan jou skenk.
It shall be light.
Amen.
And in that day when the Son of Man is being revealed.
Dit zal lig wees. En in die dag wanneer die Seun van die mens geopenbaar sal word.
If that isn't Jesus Christ the same yesterday and forever, I don't know nothing about it.
As dit nie Jesus Christus dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd is nie, dan weet ek niks daarvan.
Do you believe that?
Glo jy dit?
All things are possible to them that believe.
Alles is moontlik vir hulle wat glo.
Out upon the microphones across the land now, and in this tabernacle, how many of you will raise your hands and say, I am a believer?
Buiten op die microfone, reg oor die land nou, en in hier die tabernakel, hoeveel van julle sal julle hande opsteek en sê, ek is 'n gelowige?
Now you out there in the land, everyone's got their hands up here.
Nou, julle daar buiten in die lande, almal het hulle hande op hier.
And way out in yonder somewhere across the nation, you got your hands up no doubt.
En ver buiten, in iwers oorkant oor die nasie, het julle julle hande sonder twyfel op.
Now, close your eyes. Just drop your hands upon somebody near you.
Nou, sluit jou oë. Laat sak net jou hande op iemand naby jou.
Take a hold of their hand. Lay it upon their shoulder.
Neem hulle hand. Lay dit op hulle skouer.
I got my hands on the handkerchiefs.
Ek het my hande op die sakdoeke.
Look what's been done today. Look what's done now.
Kyk wat vandag gedoen is. Kyk wat nou gedoen is.
Beholding his hallowed face. Aglow with love divine.
Se heilige gesigte aanskou, wat skyn met goddelike liefde.
Blessed partakers of his grace, as gems in his crown to shine.
Geseënde deelgenote van sy genade, as skatte in sy kroon te skyn.
Now pray. Let's pray. Everywhere.
No, but. Laat ons oral bid.
Dear God, the hour has arrived.
Dierbare God, die uur het aangebreek.
What meaneth this? God fulfilling his word.
Wat beteken hierdie? God wat sy woord vervul.
What's the attraction, Lord?
Wat is die aantrekkingskrag, Heer?
It's God fulfilling his word.
Dis God wat sy woord vervul.
What is this that across the nation through the medium of a telephone?
Wat is dit buite oor die nasie? Deur die medium van 'n telefoon.
That hundreds of people had their hands laid on one another across the nation from one coast to the other.
Dat honderde mense hulle hand op mekaar gelê het oor die nasie van een kus na die ander.
From the north to the south, east to the west.
Vanaf die noorde na die suide, ooste na die weste.
Here sits people here from foreign countries.
Hier sit mense hier van vreemde lande.
Many of the states, Mexico, Canada, and we got our hands laid on one another.
Baie van die state, Mexico, Canada, en ons het ons hande op mekaar gelê.
God fulfilling his word.
God, wat sy woord vervul.
How is this that a person could stand here by the Holy Spirit and call a man like he did Simon Peter?
Hoe is dit dat hier 'n persoon kan staan deur die Heilige Gees? En 'n man kan roep soos hy Simon Petrus geroep het.
Your name is Simon. You are the son of Jonas.
Jou naam is Simon. Jy is die seun van Jonas.
Go get your husband and come here.
Gaan kry jou man en kom hier.
I have no husband.
Ek het geen man nie.
Truly, you have five.
Reg, jy het 5.
She said, I know that Messiah is coming to do this. But who are you?
Sy het gesê, ek weet dat Messias kom om dit te doen, maar wie is hy?
He said, I am he.
Hy het gesê, ek is hy.
And you're the same yesterday, today and forever.
En hy is dieselfde gister, vandag en vir altyd.
And you promised the works that I do, shall ye do also. More than this shall you do, because I go to the Father.
En hy het beloof, die werke wat ek doen, sal julle ook doen. Meer as dit sal julle doen, want ek gaan na die Vader.
And behold, in the last days I'll send to you the Elijah, the prophet.
En kyk, in die laaste dae sal ek vir julle die Elia, die profeet, stuur.
And he'll change the thoughts of the people.
En hy sal die gedagtes van die mense verander.
Turn the hearts of the children back to the apostolic teaching of the Bible.
Die harte van die kinders terugdraai na die apostoliese lering van die Bybel.
And it shall be light about the evening time.
En dit sal lig word teen die aandtyd.
Here we are, great God of heaven.
Hier is ons, groot God van die hemel.
The hour is here.
Die uur is hier.
The hands are upon the people.
Die hande is op die mense.
Satan, you're defeated. You are a liar.
Satan, jy is verslaan. Jy is 'n leenaar.
And as a servant of God, and a servant.
En as 'n dienskneg van God, en as diensknegte.
We command that in the name of Jesus Christ, that you obey the word of God. And go out of the people, because it's written, in my name they shall cast out devils.
Beveel ons dat in die naam van Jesus Christus, dat die woord van God gehoorsaam en uit die mense uitgaan. Want daar staan geskrywe, in my naam sal hulle duivels uitdryf.
And all the people may be set free.
En al die mense mag vrygestel word.
Grant it, dear God.
Skenk dit, dierbare God.
You are the God of heaven that defeated that day with an attraction on Mount Calvary. All sickness and diseases and all the works of the devil.
Hier is die God van die hemel, wat daar die dag met die aantrekkingskrag op Golgotha berg, alle krankhede en siektes en al die werke van die duivel verslaan het.
You are God, and the people are healed. By your stripes, they are free in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hy is God, en die mens is genees deur die wonde. Hulle is vry in die naam van Jesus Christus. Amen.
God, every handkerchief that's laying here, while the Spirit of God is present.
God, elke sakdoek wat hier lê, terwyl die Gees van God teenwoordig is.
While the anointing of Jesus Christ is upon the people, and the great signs that He promised are being fulfilled.
Terwyl die salwing van Jesus Christus op die mense is, die groot tekens wat Hy beloof het, vervul word.
And the earth is trembling, the earthquakes are happening, the great signs that He told in the scripture being fulfilled in the evening light shining.
En die aarde bewe, die aardbewings gebeur, die groot tekens wat hy vertel het, en die skrif vervul word, en die aandlig skyn.
I lay my body across these handkerchiefs, representing this whole body of believers from east, west, north and south.
Ek lê my liggaam oor hierdie sakdoeke, wat die hele liggaam van gelowiges van oos, wes, noord en suid verteenwoordig.
And say to the devil, in the name of Jesus Christ, leave every patient these are laid upon. To the honor and glory of the word of God.
En sê aan die duivel, in die naam van Jesus Christus, verlaat elke patiënt waarop hierdie gelê word, tot die eer en heerlikheid van die woord van God.
In the name of the word of God, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.
In die naam van die woord van God, Jesus Christus van Nazareth. Amen.
Now, quietly, sanely, soberly, and in your right mind, as believers.
Nou, sag, verstandelik, sober, en by julle regte positiewe as gelowiges.
Do you now believe and accept your healing from God Almighty in the name of Jesus Christ? If you do, hold up your hand.
Glo julle nou en aanvaar julle julle genesing van God Almagtig in die naam van Jesus Christus. As julle dit doen, steek op julle hande.
All out in the lands, hold up your hands out there.
Almal buiten die lande, steek julle hande daar buiten op.
Every person in here, as far as I can see, had their hands up.
Elke persoon hier binnen, so ver ek kon sien, het hulle hande opgehad.
Inside, outside, against the windows, in the doors, in the nurseries, and all around, everywhere, people with their hands up.
Binnen, buiten, teen die vensters, in die deure, in die kinderkamers, en oral rondom, mense met hulle hande op.
They accept it.
Hulle aanvaard het.
Satan is defeated.
Satan is verslaan.
The stripes of Jesus Christ heals you.
Die wonde van Jesus Christus genees julle.
And the presence of Jesus Christ verifies the fact that He's a living today ever able to keep every promise that he made. Amen.
En die teenwoordigheid van Jesus Christus bevestig die feit dat hy vandag lewe, altyd in staat om elke belofte te hou wat hy gemaak het. Amen.
I believe him, don't you?
Ek glo hom, glo julle nie?
Now let us stand up to our feet.
Nou laat ons op ons voete staan.
In the name of the Lord Jesus, accepting everything that's been done or said.
In die naam van die Here Jesus, deur alles te aanvaar wat gedoen of gesê is.
We love him with all of our hearts.
Het ons hom lief met ons hele harte.
We cherish him with all that's in us.
Ons koester hom met alles wat in ons is.
Now as you go to your different homes from tonight, God go with you.
Nou as ons hele na hele verskillende tuises gaan van vanaand af, God gaan met julle.
God give you the Holy Ghost if you don't have the Holy Ghost.
God gee julle die Heilige Gees as julle nie die Heilige Gees het nie.
Every man, woman, boy or girl here that's not been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, there's clothes, pool.
Elke man, vrou, seun of meisie hier wat nie gedoop is in die naam van Jesus Christus nie, daar is klere, bad.
Don't put off tomorrow what can be done today.
Moenie afstel vir môre wat vandag gedoen kan word nie.
Tomorrow may be too late.
Môre mag te laat wees.
Sufficient for today, for the day is the evil thereof.
Genoegsaam vir vandag, vir die dag is die kwaad daarvan.
There's ministers standing waiting. Clothes are waiting, no excuses. Are you waiting?
Daar is predikers wat staan, wag, klere wat wag, geen verskonings nie. Wag julle.
If you are, you believe. No matter how you've been baptized, sprinkled, poured, whatever it is, it's an era.
As julle wag, glo julle. Maak nie saak hoe julle gedoop is nie, besprinkel, gegiet, wat het ook al is. Dis 'n fout.
The light has come. Come believe and be baptized.
Die lig het gekom. Kom, glo en word gedoop.
Everyone without the Holy Ghost, may you receive the Holy Ghost. Every one of you.
Elkeen sonder die Heilige Gees, mag julle die Heilige Gees ontvang. Elkeen van julle.
In the full divine power and love that he promised you to make you a new creature in him. God bless you.
In die volle goddelike krag en liefde wat hy julle beloof het om julle 'n nuwe skepsel in hom te maak. God seën julle.
Now, till next Sunday morning at 9:30, let's sing this little song that we used to sing years ago.
Nou, tot volgende Sondagoggend om 9:30, laat ons hierdie liedjie sing wat ons altyd jare gelede gesing het.
Don't forget the family prayer.
Moenie die gesinsgebed vergeet nie.
Jesus wants to meet you there.
Jesus wil jou daar ontmoet.
He will take your every care.
Hy sal elke sorg van jou neem.
Don't forget the family prayer.
Moenie die gesinsgebed vergeet nie.
Let's sing it together now.
Laat ons dit nou saam sing.
Don't forget the family prayer. Jesus wants to meet you there. Hey, he will take your every care. Oh, don't forget the family prayer. Now, as we sing it again, shake hands with the pilgrim next to you. See? As we sing it.
Moenie die gesinsgebed vergeet nie. Jesus wil jou daar ontmoet. Hy sal elke sorg van jou neem. O, moenie die gesinsgebed vergeet nie. Nou, soos ons dit weer sing, skud hand met 'n pelgrim langs jou sien, soos ons dit sing.
Don't forget the family prayer. Oh, Jesus wants to meet you there. He will take your every care. Oh, don't forget the family prayer. Don't you love him?
Moenie die gesinsgebed vergeet nie. O, Jesus wil jou daar ontmoet. Hy sal elke sorg van jou neem. O, moenie die gesinsgebed vergeet nie. Het jy hom nie lief nie?
I love him because he first loved me and purchased my salvation. That was attraction on Mount Calvary.
Ek het hom lief omdat hy my eerste lief gehad het en my verlossing gekoop het. Dit was die aantrekkingskrag op Golgotha berg.
The same attraction on Sunset Mountain.
Dieselfde aantrekkingskrag op Sunset berg.
Mount Nebo, Mount Sinai, all the different mountaintop experiences.
Neboberg, Sinaiberg, al die verschillende bergtopondervindings.
Then, all right, let's sing it now.
Dan goed, laat ons dit nou sing.
I
love you.
Say amen.
Ek het hom lief, ek het hom lief, omdat hy my eerste lief gehad het. En verlossing op Golgotha se boom. Almal wat hom lief het, sê amen.
So, now just think of what he's done for you.
Laat het so wees. Nou dink net aan wat hy vir jou gedoen het.
Think that you could be out there in a bar room tonight.
Dink dat jy daar buite in 'n kroeg kon wees vanaand.
You probably would have been in the grave like I should have been outside the mercies of God.
Jy sou waarskynlik in die graf gewees het, soos ek behoort te gewees het, buite die genade van God.
What did he do for you?
Wat het hy vir jou gedoen?
Oh, how could we keep from loving him?
Hoe kan ons hom nie lief hê nie?
Don't make any difference what anybody says. He's first.
Maak nie saak wat enige iemand sê nie, hy is eerste.
Let's close your eyes. Bow our heads as we sing it to him now.
Laat ons oë sluit en ons hoofde buig, soos ons dit nou tot hom sing.
He likes songs, singing hymns.
Hy hou van liedere, gesange sing.
Let's sing it to him now.
Laat ons dit nou tot hom sing.
With our heads and hearts bowed in his presence.
Ek het hom lief, ek het hom lief, omdat hy my eerste lief gehad het, en my verlossing gekoop het op Golgotha se boom. Met ons hoofde en harte gebuig in sy teenwoordigheid.
Gratefulness for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard.
Dankbaar vir wat ons oë gesien het, wat ons ore gehoor het.
What's recorded in God's word. What his promise has been to us today, God bless you.
Wat opgeteken is in God se woord, wat sy belofte vir ons was vandag, God seën julle.
We have a guest with us tonight, a brother, Ned Iverson, formerly a Presbyterian minister.
Ons het 'n gas by ons vanaand, 'n broer, Ned Iverson, vroeër 'n Presbyteriaanse prediker.
His father, his brothers, our Presbyterian minister.
Sy pa, sy broers is Presbyteriaanse prediker.
He, I understand, was baptized today again in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hy, verstaan ek, is vandag gedoop weer in die naam van Jesus Christus.
He's a minister and a good one at that.
Hy is 'n prediker en 'n goeie een op die koop toe.
And now I'm going to ask him, as I believe him to be God's servants, to ask God's blessings upon this congregation as you go to your home.
En nou gaan ek hom vra, omdat ek glo hy is God se dienaars, om God se seëninge oor hierdie gemeente te vra, soos julle na julle huis gaan.
Brother Iverson, come forward. While we have our heads bowed in prayer. God bless you, my brother.
Broer Iverson, kom vorentoe. Terwyl ons hoofde gebuig het in gebed, God seën jou, my broer.